your volume up, Mitch, because I barely can hear you.
Well, I'm not talking at the mic.
Oh, okay, there we go.
Yeah, I gotta be actually talking at the mic.
Right, I couldn't hear.
I'll be more like this. Our mics are coming through right now.
Huh?
Our mics are coming through right now.
Hi, everybody!
Hey! Yellow! The rest of that. I was jamming hard. I was really feeling it in my soul.
Yeah. Get over yourself.
Hey.
Alright, so before we get started,
I need to sip this. That's what we need to do.
You need to sip that. You need to sip it super slow. So, hold on just a second. So, as everybody should be aware by now, Satoru Iwata, who is the CEO of Nintendo, has passed away as of last night, which is, unfortunately, we've lost a very important and good person in the gaming industry.
At such a young age, too, only 55.
He was only 55, and it's really a bummer that he's passed on, and we're definitely going to miss him because he's done so much for not only Nintendo, but for gaming as a whole. I mean, he's really pushed Nintendo into the bounds of almost mythic status in terms of their gaming and their product. And while we, you know, have our moments where we like to pick on Nintendo a bit, right now we've definitely come to a point where we've lost one of the great ones.
Yeah.
So I wanna start our show on a more somber note than normal with a quote from Mr. Iwata himself. He said, "On my business card, I'm a corporate president. In my mind, I'm a game developer. But in my heart, I'm a gamer." And those we really need to kind of cling to, those words, because regardless of what it says on your business card,
regardless of the title you have,
regardless of where you live and what you do, we're all gamers.
Exactly.
And we're all part of this wacky community of games.
A great community, though.
And it is a great community. It's varied and huge. And you know, we...
That was Iwata.
No, we're not going there. But we, you know, we pick on each other a lot in the gaming industry, and we call each other names, and we rage, and we fight, and we get mad at each other. But one thing is constant. We're all gamers. And that's the important thing to take away from this. And so I'd like to have... Let me fix this first. I'd like to have a moment of silence for Mr. Iwata before we begin, and then we'll go ahead and pick up the show as normal, because Mr. Iwata would definitely want people to be happy and playing games and enjoying
letting the games go on.
That's right. So let's have a moment of silence for Mr. Iwata. Thank you. Thank you, Mr. Iwata, for all you've done for us. And I hope Nintendo continues to kick butt and do some awesome things. And I appreciate you guys being patient with that.
He'll always be missed.
He will be. He'll never be forgotten. So he will. His legacy will live on. And I think that's more than most of us will get. So
a lot of us will get.
So, yeah, he'll be missed sorely. But Nintendo will chug on. And... there will always be a place in our hearts for Mr. Iwata and his creations and what he's, you know, pushed forward.
What he represents.
And what he represents, for sure. So, with that, let's begin the show. My name is Tim.
I'm George.
And welcome to Insert Coin Theater. We are a games discussion.
Well, welcome back.
Welcome back, yeah. We took a week off. We've kind of been on and off a little bit. We're going to try to avoid doing that in the future as much as we can, unless there are more pressing matters. So, we really... are excited to have you here. We're going to be talking games. If you are with us here on Twitch Live, please feel free to pop into chat. Speak your mind.
Say hello.
Come up with any topics you may want to discuss. Whatever. We're open. We're going to continue on with the show, and we're gonna do our thing. So
don't have to mourn too much.
Yeah. I mean, it is kind
of bring everybody up.
Well,
now.
It truly is a bit of a gloomy day. I mean, if you look at everything that has been going on since last night, there's been a lot of art dedicated to him.
Oh my gosh, man.
And I mean, it's pretty
on your heartstrings, man. Some of those pieces.
Yeah, it really does. So it's something where we as a community of gamers can come together and really. You know, and really,
I saw some things too that I thought would be a really cool idea.
Like
that people were talking about having him as an amiibo, which I think would be really cool.
That would be amazing. Yeah, that would be really cool.
Like a really awesome way to, you know, send him off almost. You know, everyone can buy a little amiibo of Iwata. That would be
awesome.
Put him in Smash or something.
Hi to Shenanigans.
How's it going?
He seems to be confused that we only have like three people in the channel right now. And it's true. We're small and we're trying to grow.
We're
so you know
guys.
we're gonna keep doing what we do. And I understand that it might be smaller than what you're comfortable with, and that's okay. We're okay with that because we're growing, and that's how growing works. And I apologize if it's not what you expect, but I'm not trying to be a jerk either. I really am not. I'm just being honest that you know we're doing what we can. And
at least you came in.
I know.
Thank
we appreciate it. We truly, truly do. And if it's not for you, I understand, because you know most people can't take more than just a few minutes of me. And George, I mean, is like 10 seconds. So,
exactly.
So, yeah.
About as long as I last.
So, sorry if it's not what you expect, but we hope you'll stay around and maybe you'll check like it. And if you don't, tell us we suck. We're cool with that. I mean,
But tell your friends we're awesome.
So,
lie to them.
We love doing the show. And, you know, we might have had a week off, but, you know, we're making the...
We're going to try to stay steady now.
We're going to do
our best.
We're going to do our best. So, So, this show, this episode is definitely dedicated to Satoru Iwata.
As much as we can.
We're gonna keep talking about games, and we're gonna keep poking fun at Nintendo because we want them to do better, and we want them to do the best they can because I'm sure that's what he would want. And we're gonna make fun of everybody because that's what we do.
That's what makes it fun. If you're not making fun of somebody.
Oh, hi to Emily Maddox. Hey to CB.
How's it going?
Roll Tide. Hold on. CB Roll Tide. Wolf is in here.
You too, man.
And Gerboss was in here earlier. Appreciate you guys coming along and hanging out with us as we discuss some games. So we got a little bit planned tonight, but we're just going to mainly be talking.
It's just be flowing.
We're catching up. So again, if you have
any topic
that you
want
to talk about,
them.
Just feel free to kick it in the chat, and we can come back on it. If you want to hate on us, it gives us power. It makes us money.
We feed on it.
Except for Wolf and Gerboss, who are regulars, they're not allowed to pick on me because they do it all
they
the time.
They can pick on me.
Well, I know.
I don't mind.
That's good. Pick on him.
Yeah, pick on me. Say something. What does that person always say? Something? Tell me how dry I make you.
Oh, jeez. Oh, that was something.
It was awesome. That was so awesome. So what have you been playing, man? What have you been playing?
I have been playing a ton of Dirty Bomb. Have you ever
Dirty
heard
Bomb.
Of Dirty
that,
Bomb?
I feel like that is like an innuendo to something.
You'd think. But actually, you know, a Dirty Bomb is normally like a nuclear device that is released in like a populated area. And the whole story behind
smelly.
It is the whole idea behind it is...
Behind the game or behind,
behind
the dirty
game
bomb?
Is that it's post-apocalyptic, post-nuclear London, right? And so you're playing a slew of different characters that have different perks, kind of like League of Legends a little bit in that regard.
Is it like a Dota, though?
No, it's not a MOBA at all.
Okay.
It's objective-based first-person shooter. So you have, in the regular objective mode, you have one team attacking, one team defending. Excuse me. And the attacker team is trying to like plant bombs or
would you say they're planting dirty bombs?
No. It's like a variety of things or steal drug samples or things like that from
now we're talking.
It's pretty cool. And it's a lot of fun. It's a free to play, which is really cool, and it's on Steam right now, and I'm really having a lot of fun with it. I've probably put like 20 or 30 hours in it in the
really?
Last
wow.
week. I've put a lot of time
nice.
Into it. And it's quite fun. I've been playing with a few folks from the stream, namely CB Roll Tide Wolf.
Is it only
Shout
online?
Yeah, it's only an online. There's no single player. But you can actually, you can either save up credits and purchase characters, much like League of Legends, or you can put cash into it and pay for it and get characters. And it's a lot of fun because it really... You can play either attack or defend, and there's enough maps. I think there's like 7 or 8 maps, which is pretty decent, and they're a pretty decent size. And it's pretty cool. It really is.
So is it only objective based, or is there team deathmatch?
No,
or?
Not yet. I mean, it's still a beta, so it's not.
Okay.
It's not complete.
It's still
I forgot
like
to
early,
specify.
Okay.
And to Lizard Squad DOS, that is not our Skype, but I've got a Skype, but that's. That's what I use when I talk to the people that I play with.
The people. I like how you said the people.
The people. I do play with a few of our stream
there you go.
Followers every once in a while, which is a lot of fun.
So the only thing there is now is the one objective game type.
Yeah, and then there's stopwatch where you do on and off. So it swaps defenders and attackers at a mid-game.
Like after each round?
Yeah, and then there's a competitive, like, what is it called? Like a... ranked mode, thank you.
Are
That's
the objectives
the
same
for.
Every time, or is there like a few different types of objectives you can do?
Each map has different objectives.
Oh, okay.
So
it's map
it's very
specific.
Mixed up, but it's really nice because you get these different maps, and you can play with a squad of yours, like with friends. Right now, their matchmaking's a little weird because you can't like join a match with your friends. Like, you can't make a party and then join.
Oh,
you have
so
to join
just,
a server,
and
then they have to
time?
Wait to join a server with you. So it has some work that it needs to be done. But overall, I'm actually fairly impressed with what they've done with it, and I've been quite pleased with it. I mean, okay. I feel like it's worth spending a little money on. And I think,
now, it's not pay to win, though, right?
No, because the way that the loadouts are done, and this is really interesting, is they're done with cards, and each card has different weapons and different perks. And so there's a chance you could get a card with really really crappy perks.
Yeah.
Okay? Or you could get a card with really good perks, and, you know, it's a perfect card.
When you get those cards, do you keep... Is it, like, a certain amount of time you get to use this weapon, or once you unlock that weapon, you got it forever? Because I can't remember what game it was, but, like, it might have been Blacklight, or some game that you would, like, you could purchase the guns, but that you'd only be able to use the gun for, like, 7 days, or, like, depending on how much you spent on it, you could either, like... It was almost renting it.
It doesn't... There's no rental. Once you have a card, that card stays in your inventory.
Okay, so you just...
Yeah. And you can also, you can also buy the mercenaries, which let you use those cards. And there's different levels of cards. There's, like... it starts at lead, goes to iron, then goes to bronze, then silver, gold, and cobalt, which is the best. The cobalt cards have, they're the best cards because they have the best combination of perks and stuff like that. But it's not to the point where it totally breaks the game or anything like that. So
yeah, but I remember you telling me too. So is there's like a character that's really OP right now, you were saying? Or there's, like, some, like, invisible guy or something?
Yeah, they just did a patch. They added a character called Phantom, which apparently was removed before because it was broken.
Oh, wow, so it came and then now they took it away and
I guess
back.
They did some tweaking or something to try to fix it.
It didn't work.
No, it definitely did. And it's unfortunate because he has the ability to go invisible, which pretty much makes him invincible. Because it gives him like 4 times the damage soak when he's invisible. So if he runs over a proximity mine, he doesn't take it.
Just absorbs
much damage.
It.
Yeah, pretty much.
Mm-hmm.
And he has the ability to pretty much one-shot you with his katana. He has a katana.
Oh, wow.
And he's
is
a
he
cool
only
character.
Melee?
Yeah. Well, he can use regular guns too. And that's the thing that's crazy is because he can go invisible, melee, one-shot you. And the thing is that the swing on the melee weapon is so wide. He can take out like 2 or 3 people with one swing. So if you've got people that are clustered together in a firefight,
boom,
he just runs in and takes
them out.
And it's really ridiculous because he can actually take out some of the more heavy tank characters in one hit.
Oh, so characters actually have different stats then?
Yeah, because if you play, for example, there's a character called Proxy. She can lay proximity mines. She's really fast. She can jump around a lot, and she uses like shotguns or submachine guns. And she's a pretty cool character in the regard. I keep saying cool. She's an interesting character because.
You can just say cool,
I just keep
man.
Saying
cool, really
cool, cool. Hey, cool, 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 cool. It's I'm just getting.
That reminds me of what's that one movie? Hot Rod. Cool, cool beans, cool. Beans, beans.
So she
movie,
has like
way,
90 health, right?
Oh God. So
whereas
she's like,
whereas
she's a mage, pretty much.
Whereas yeah, pretty much. She's a glass cannon a little bit. If you know how to play her, you can really get dodgy and dodge a lot of the attacks. She's more of a scout character.
So there's not, like, parkour. When you say she jumps around a lot, she just does, like, a double
jump? And then if you get on a wall, you can actually,
like,
double
vaulting?
Jump.
Oh.
And then some of the perks give you a triple jump. So you can actually go boing, boing, boing.
That seems like it'd be pretty interesting.
It is interesting, but it's not the greatest perk because there's not a lot of places to really utilize that. Because you have to bounce off walls.
So are the maps, like, pretty open then? It's not, like,
some of the maps. There's some closed areas. It depends on the map. So it's very dependent. But that's why you get different cards and have multiple cards per character.
Okay, so do you, like, just, like, equip a certain amount of cards per match?
You get a squad of 3.
Okay.
And you can pick the same character multiple times with different
cards.
Oh,
you personally get a squad of 3.
Yes.
Okay, I thought you meant,
you get
like,
to pick from 3 in the game. So you get... You could say you could pick Proxy, you can pick Fragger, who throws grenades.
Oh, that's pretty awesome.
And you can pick Aura, who's a healer. So, like, if the situation calls for it, you could switch to a healer and go help
mid-battle, or...
Yeah, once you die, you have the option to switch.
Now, once you die, is that one gone for the round
and you just have
the last two?
You keep them, and you can keep respawning as them. Yeah,
okay.
So if you get... It's just like a traditional... It's very arcadey, very fast-paced,
yeah,
and that's
why I like
it so much.
Like Team Fortress?
Like Team Fortress, it reminds me of Team Fortress mixed with League of Legends mixed with Counter-Strike Global Offensive.
Okay, now...
So, because it's got the objectives, whereas I know Team Fortress does, but it's got, like, a little bit of the quirk that Team Fortress does,
but
not quite so
much. Now, when you say League of Legends, Is there like other mobs, or is it purely just the player? I say like League of Legends, player.
And their purchase model is almost identical. It's where you can use either credits to purchase a character, the credits you earn from matches, or you can just pay the money. And the same thing goes with like the cards. You can buy cases with real money, or you can just buy you can buy the base cases with credits. And Wolf is saying that they tweaked Phantom today, so I'll have to check that out sometime soon. Okay. And hopefully it's a fair tweak, and I won't have any reason to complain
anymore. Usually, I feel like they have a tendency to make someone OP, and then they nerf it too hard.
Well, here's my hunch. And I know this is speaking ill of the developers. I hate doing that, because Splash Damage.
Okay.
Right. Same people made Wolfenstein, one of the Wolfenstein games.
Not the New Order, right?
No, no, one of the older ones. But they've done a lot of games, and they're pretty veteran.
Yeah.
But I feel like they created the character, made him really OP so they'd sell a lot, and now they've tweaked him down to nothing so that they've got the money. That's what it feels
really
like.
Really shady, man.
And I don't mean to say it like that. I don't, you know, that's just how it comes across to me. Mm-hmm. So I don't know. Yeah, that's what I've been
playing. It sounds pretty good, man.
It is. I really enjoy it. I think it's one of those games that has a lot of longevity to it.
Are people already like super good at it?
Some games that I get into, it's not even fun. Like, you get to a point where your highest player on your team has maybe 1,000, 2,000 points, and then their highest player
HP
has, like,
talking about?
No points. You get points for kills and doing objective stuff and things like that.
HP
points. So your highest points is like, on your team is like 2,000 points. Their highest is like 12,000, and they're just steamrolling you. And it's like they really need to work on match balance, like really badly. They really need match balance, and they also really need.
Would you say more often than not you get in heavy-sided matches?
Unfortunately, it's about 50-50. Sometimes you're in a really good match where you're like within
spot on
within like everyone's within like 100 points of each other. Like the first player on your team is within 100 of theirs and stuff like that. That I love, and I could deal with that all day. Yeah. I mean, that's the way to play it. But
that's how I feel a game should be. You know?
I agree.
And I don't want it to be heavy-handed.
If they would track stats better, like how people play,
they
like
can better arrange
then,
groups.
Then do like if you get, you know, person A that's really, really good, then they put person B that's really, really good on the other team automatically, and then they auto-balance in the middle of the game and things. I would be okay with that. Mm-hmm. That's the way that I would want to see it. I mean,
Has this been in beta? Like, how long has it been around?
I mean, I just found out about it like a week ago.
Yeah, because you were saying that they took that guy out and brought him back in, so it makes me wonder how long it's been.
It used to be called something else, and then they renamed it, the game. Okay. And then,
so it could have been out for quite a bit now, then.
Yeah. I just can't remember what it was called, and I don't know a lot about the history of it. I just know what it is now. Mm. And I've been having fun with it.
And what's it called again? Dirty Bomb?
Dirty Bomb, it's pretty cool, and it's free to play.
It's not
on
high specs, right?
I don't think so. I don't think it's super high. I think you can tweak it down a bit.
Mm-hmm.
Yeah, so it's a lot of fun, and I really enjoy it. I know older machines can play it, so it's pretty good.
Dirty Bomb, I'll have to check
Dirty
it out.
Dirty Bomb.
Man. I like multiplayer games.
Dirty Bomb.
This
must be. Wait, what?
Is that the theme song or something?
No, that's NSYNC's Pop. The song Pop by NSYNC.
What? You're bringing back No,
I'm bringing
dead.
It back, baby.
Leave them gone,
I'm bringing it back,
man.
Baby.
Leave them gone.
that's Dirty Pop, but
that
with Dirty Bomb.
I was, you know, going through the car wash, you know, and I was cleaning the cars, and then this, I think it might have been Backstreet Boys came, and I was like, no.
Which song was it?
I was like, punch. Which I don't song even know. It? I didn't even give it a chance.
Was it
even,
I Want It That Way?
It might have been. I feel like I hate that song enough for that. Is probably what it was. I felt like just punching the radio. Just the thought that that was even
come
playing
on, George.
Irritated me.
Am I your fire? Your one desire?
No. I don't want any fire. If you're my fire, I'm just gonna jump into a river and just oust myself.
Put it out. Put it out. No.
Gosh, man.
So what have you been playing, man?
I've been doing a little mix. I've been playing. Actually, I just did a free trial. I think I've had it for like 3 days right now.
Yeah.
And I just did the 7-day free trial of the PlayStation Now service, where you get to play.
Yeah.
It's like streaming.
I did the beta
old games.
Yeah.
Yeah. Did you like it?
It was cool. The beta had a lot of issues, but they resolved them since. Like right at the end, I logged in of the beta, and it was perfect. So, so they've really done a good job.
I just started my 7-day free trial of that, so I've just been playing a lot of Shadow Colossus, actually.
Really?
That's a
classic
game, man.
The
controls for that game
are awful?
Horrible.
Dude, it was before they really...
Horrible.
It was before they really, like, standardized that stuff.
But I remembered it being just, like, one of the most amazing games ever, you know? Just the whole concept and, you know, just the idea behind it all was just so good. And then I get back to it and, like, riding the horse is almost impossible. Like, it is the most difficult thing. Like, the whole time, all the horse is doing is like this. Because I'm trying to steer it, and it's just like... there's no, like, small movements when you turn. Like, everything's... If you press to the right, he's doing a Yui, man. He's going fully around. So you have to just keep going back
and forth. So it's no Epona from Ocarina of Time.
No. This is, like, the most challenged horse I've ever seen.
Does it make you worry about their new game?
No. They've had the enough time.
The controls are going to be identical. You get on the back of that thing, and it's just like...
And it's funny, because my nephews will be, like, watching me play, and they're like, what's happening? I'm like, I can't control the horse! Because you have to just go back and forth to make it go straight, because
right.
It makes such drastic moves. So I'm, like, trying to go down this, like, narrow bridge, and the horse is just... To try to keep going straight, I'm like, I'm just going to end myself.
That's awesome.
But after a little bit, I'm starting to get back to
it. It's a classic, though, man.
It really is so good. You just got to get back.
You got
to
get
used
to
what it, what it was.
It's a classic,
though. And now that I've played it for a while and I, you know, changed up some of the control button config, it's pretty good now.
It's a little better.
Yeah, but man, that horse.
So just to let you know, Jerboss said, I want it that
why
way.
Why did you start this, man? This is your fault.
I've turned them against you,
I
George.
Know, gosh. Now you're just going to have an army of NSYNC Backstreet Boys guys on me.
I'm forming my own Backstreet Boys.
There's going to be boy bands outside my house. You're like, George,
we're called the Back Alley Babies.
That sounds horrible.
It wasn't supposed to sound good.
Those babies need to be saved. Anyway, so I've been playing that, enjoying the heck out of it. I think I'm, like, up to 7 Colossi beaten.
Nice. Nice use of the
12,
plural,
right?
Colossi.
Thank you.
I like
thank
that.
You.
I like
thank
that.
You.
Very
I've
nice.
Been practicing that all day, actually. And
took you all
game,
day?
Exactly. I've been waiting for my one opportunity to use it, and here it is.
Colossi.
I'm
going to use that in a sentence.
I should have pulled out my monocle.
Put on a top hat.
Exactly. Indubitably.
How many colossi have I caught today?
Quite. My cane sword.
Indubitably, quite.
And what else I've been playing? Rocket quite. League, actually.
Rocket League, what's
it
that?
It just came out for
that,
PlayStation
that's like,
4.
That was on PS3, wasn't it?
I think so.
I honestly played it. That,
since.
Is that the game where you're like a go-kart almost, and you're
yeah,
like
you're
launching
like this,
around and launching a ball
mm-hmm.
into a...
And you can drive on the walls.
Yeah, yep.
Like,
that was,
I literally got an achievement, or not achievement, sorry, a trophy for, it's called like
bastard.
Spider something or other. And it's like, spend 5 minutes on the wall. So, like, every match I'm just like, circling around the whole thing, because why not? You're
why
in a rocket
not?
Jet car.
You know it, you know it.
You can just pull off really awesome stuff. And I like it because it's not too hectic, because it's, I think the max is 4-on-4. It can be.
Oh,
the
arenas
are pretty big. It's like, I don't know, I can't compare it to a real soccer field.
So you can do some really crazy stuff.
Yeah,
because
you get the boost, right? And if you jump and use the boost, you can literally, like, fly.
Really?
You can just
that's
rocket
cool.
yourself into the air. And you also get dodge. Like, if you press X twice, first one you'll jump, and if you press in any direction, it'll do like a barrel roll to the
cool.
side.
So you can dodge like missiles or whatever. Are there missiles?
There's
no weapons.
There's no weapons. It's purely just soccer.
Really? There's no
cars.
Explosions or
zero.
Anything.
The only thing that explodes is if you get a goal, the ball explodes and like throws everybody away from the goal. But
I don't remember that very
much. No,
so
rocket,
I remember
no,
playing it,
yeah,
but I don't remember
no
it very well.
No weapons or anything, but you can like front flip and like tail whip, you know, the ball into people.
Oh, that's cool.
It's really fun. There
sounds really
you
competitive.
You can pull off some really. Yeah, but it's not so much to where, you know,
it's
just
not
chaos,
frustratingly
you know,
competitive.
Exactly.
It's
you know, so you
more
can have
organized
up to four,
chaos.
Yeah, like I said, 4-on-4. Really fun, arcadey, just, you know, fun out of the ordinary game.
That's
you know
nice.
Me, I hate sports games.
Yeah.
This, I think, is like the first sports game ever. Like, this is pretty awesome.
Mario Tennis, bro.
This makes me want to play real soccer with cars.
No. Yeah, with cars. Only if there's cars involved.
Exactly, and we can do flips and barrel rolls. But
dual barrel roll.
It's really fun.
Yeah.
It's pretty fun.
Oh, that's cool.
Rocket League. Free right
Rocket
now.
Rocket League.
Yeah.
Well,
check
I've been
it out.
I've been playing this crazy Japanese game called Mitsurugi Kamui Hike. I know it sounds friggin' weird, and it is friggin' weird. All right, so
when you said Japanese, I knew that
well,
was coming. It like
you know, normally I'll pick games that look fun, but I'm not one, you know me and hack and slashes. Mm-hmm. I'm not much. This is a hack and slash, and I'm in love, dude.
Really?
It's so ridiculous. It is.
That is not your
well,
your
let me tell you. Let me tell you. All right, so you play a Japanese schoolgirl, okay?
I'm in. I'll take three.
Your classmate, who is another Japanese schoolgirl, has gotten a sword that's a demon sword that's slowly draining her life and creating these demons that you have to fight in waves.
Sounds okay? like another game that...
And it is the most, like I play with a controller, and just, like, my fingers hurt. Like, it feels like my fingers are going to bleed.
Is it super arcadey, or is there pretty strategy?
It's extremely arcadey. There's some strategy, but it's...
So you can pretty much just spam, and you're good to go.
Yes and no. It depends on what you're fighting.
Mm-hmm.
Whoa, excuse me. That's that monster catching up with me. It's extremely fast-paced. That's the thing.
Okay.
And it's arcadey in that sense, but certain monsters take different tactics to really defeat. So it's an interesting game. I've been playing it on stream, so a couple of our followers have seen this. It's a fascinating game in the sense that, like, you can upgrade almost all of your abilities and get more combos added onto them. So you do more combos, and you can do air combos and stuff like that. And it's really weird. And I gotta say this. I apologize if it's borderline, but there are panty shots galore in this game. I mean, it is the most ridiculous. Like, you do a backflip, and you know it's like
it's
the skirt flies
on.
Up, and it's just like. It's like somebody came into the stream and was like, man, the amount of panty shots is not enough for me in this. And I'm like, dang,
I
man.
Twice as
there's,
many
there's,
panty
there's,
shots.
There's shows for that, you know?
That's
a lot of
I have to say, that would be. I would probably high-five that guy.
Or lady. It was pretty interesting, though. It's a pretty cool game, and it's very frustrating and very difficult. I can
you
only
feel
play
like
it in small bursts.
It's too campy, though? Like, it's trying to just be too outrageous?
No,
or
like
do you think
it's
solid
so
game.
Weird. It's just so weird that I have trouble categorizing it because it's not campy, because it's not like gratuitous. It's not like
so
oh, look at panties.
Like
it doesn't
like
zoom in,
it down your
and it's not like oh, look at panties. You know, it's just you do
you
a backflip and it happens
okay.
to like real skirts would. You know, and so it's just a weird game because the demons you fight look like robots and people in suits and.
Yeah.
Like, the bosses are so difficult. Mm-hmm. Oh, my God. They are so hard.
Yeah, because I was wondering if it's just pure, you know, just for the sake of panty shots, it's, you know, they just threw
no,
a game with panties in there.
I think it's more fan service and less ecchi, which is perverted. Like, it's less the focus and more of just a side
and
effect.
It's just like, yeah, if you're in a skirt and you're fighting and flipping,
and I'm not
that's
complaining,
what's gonna
don't
happen.
Get me wrong, because it's a great, it's, you know, it's a good thing, you know, but...
I'm for the panties.
I'm all
pro
for the
panties.
Panties, you know. I am in the pro panties camp, if you know what I'm saying, but...
So, that's awesome.
So, yeah, so it's a great game, a little weird.
And there's
Mitsurugi
enough depth to keep
Kamuike,
you
I
going.
Guess, is what it's... Is. I don't know how to pronounce it, so that's how I'm going to pronounce it. But, yeah, there's enough depth with the upgrades, and it's simple. It's not like it's this super
like
massive arcing story. It's a simple story where you're just trying to save your friend and fighting crazy freaking demons.
How many hours would you say you've put into... Not many?
Just a couple. Okay. Like, I mean, it's probably maybe like 3 or 4 hours, if that. I mean,
you
it's
think
not long.
That's how many
it
you put in, or you
though.
Think that's
like
how many
$2
the game's
on
gonna...
a summer sale? I think it's only
so
going to be like...
It wouldn't even matter if it was like a four-hour game for $2. It doesn't...
With getting my butt kicked as many times as I have, it might be 6, because I suck. But I suck at games in general. We all know this, so yeah.
Yeah. So it's a 10-hour game for you?
yeah, pretty much. But I've definitely gotten the money out of it, and it's worthwhile for the price. I think it's like $10 normally, maybe, I want to say, and that's not bad.
Yeah, that's...
It's pretty decent, and I'm enjoying it. The next game I want to get is called Akiba's Trip. I told you about this game, I think.
Akiba's Trip.
Akiba's Trip.
Akiba's?
Akiba.
Oh, okay.
Like
Akibas.
Akibara, the Tokyo district.
Yeah.
It's another crazy Japanese game I want to get. Finally came out on PC a little while ago. A little expensive right now. I think it's like $40 or $50. Mm. A little out of my price range at the moment.
Is
but
it an older game?
No. It was out on PS3 not super long ago.
Like, so towards the end
no,
of the
PS3
era?
Maybe it was PS4.
Era?
Maybe it's on PS4. I can't remember. They just released it, though, on PC.
Okay.
So...
And it was Japan only, I'm assuming?
At first,
or
then
it
got then
released?
It got localized over here, and then they finally released it on PC. I want to pick it up because it's crazy, because it's in this, a similar vein where it's like the weird like fan service. Well, the premise of the game is that there are these like monster alien things that have taken over Akihabara, right?
Mm-hmm.
Mm-hmm. And you're supposed to find all the aliens, these evil creatures. And the only way to do that is by, the only way to kill them is to identify them, then rip their clothes off because they look like humans. So you have to go up to just like people that are aliens that you know are aliens and rip their clothes off and then they like dissolve or something.
So like once they get naked, they're, we can't handle this.
I don't think there's nudity. I think you just get them down to the underwear and then, but it's one of those games that's like fan service-y but also a little etchy, you know, that sort of thing. So it's one of those games that I want to play just because...
Tis the sake of seeing what it's about.
The morbid curiosity mixed with the being pro panties.
Good enough reason for me. Good enough reason for me.
So Jerboss asked, do we like Call of Duty games? So, George, why don't you start? Why don't you take this one? Come on, bro. Come on. Be honest, but don't be too harsh. Don't be too terribly
harsh. Then I can't
be
honest.
Then be honest. Just be honest. Just do it. By the by, we're drinking Monster Rehabs today. Again, we're not,
we need rehabilitation.
We are not paid by anybody. Unfortunately, I wish we were paid by some people. But
besides
these are really good.
Actual job.
Actually,
that's who we're
paid
for.
Yeah, right. The ones that we actually work because we have to work for a living. But yeah, these are surprisingly good.
Not bad.
We got this Japan crate. If you've never heard of it, they send you a crate full of candy and a Japanese
fun
drink
snacks.
On the premium. We're gonna open this thing
I got
up
you
today.
Added on the premium.
Yeah, well, there's a premium version that's $30. It's 2-day shipping in the U.S. and it's full of Japanese candies.
Fun stuff.
Really fun. We're gonna open this up towards the end
of
the
show. It's like a party in a box.
Yeah, we'll sample some of these things and it'll be a lot of fun. But
anyway, so
Call of Duty. Let's do it.
I used to like Call of Duty back in its earlier days. Not like super, super early, you know, when it was like first coming out. It's like...
I think it went around 4.
Yeah, probably.
Modern Warfare and...
yeah, about Modern
World
Warfare
of
is
War
probably
and
when,
the first Black Ops in that area.
I used to like it a lot, but now it's just too cash grabby, and it's just... I feel like it's lost what it used to have, you know what I mean? It's just been now I feel like they just... pump them out for the sake of pumping them out.
Well, it's a yearly now.
Yeah.
It's every year.
Which I always feel makes a franchise suffer because...
Assassin's Creed, anyone?
Yeah. It becomes less about the game and more about...
Money?
Money. And, you know, they just want to shoot them out. The quality slips and I feel bad because, you know, the developers might actually be like, let's put a lot of work...
Thanks for the follow, Hard Bulldog 37. Yeah. Appreciate it, man.
I feel like maybe they do care, and you know some of the developers that are making them are sitting there like, yeah, this is going to be the best Call of Duty ever.
Yep.
But I feel like it's not that. Like, I feel like they're more just sitting there, okay, we got to get this out quick, you know, because our deadline is such and such a time, and we have to make the next Call of Duty 47, 92, 86, 7.
Right.
You know, just to make it again.
Call of Duty so, Black Ops 7.
Exactly. It's just, I don't... They're not... There's not as much time spent on them as there used to be, and I think it's really suffering big time. Because Modern Warfare, that story alone was awesome.
Yeah,
it was
amazing.
Just so solid, and the gameplay
two
was really
okay. Three was.
I felt like that's when
three
it
was like
two. It was just like, you know, going down.
And I know they have two different studios working on it.
Yes,
but I feel the same way as you. I mean. I actually dusted off Modern Warfare a little while ago, and it was on the PC, and it was just as fun as I remember. I mean, it was all hackers.
Yeah.
I mean, because that's all that's left in that game.
Yeah, once the next one comes out, those servers just...
Oh,
they don't even care anymore.
They drop off. I mean, because they moved their servers from being on that game to the new game.
Call of Duty 12 now.
That's right. So, you know, Wolf says From Ghosts On was awful, and you know I tend to agree it was pretty bad, but I think even a little before that is when it got pretty bad.
Mm-hmm. It was definitely started to slip earlier, I think, than that. But
because I'm in the same I'm in the same boat as you. Mm-hmm. I like the combat that it represents. I love the combat style that they have. Mm-hmm. I love that they really championed hit markers big time.
Yeah.
And that was a big thing from them. I don't think they were the first to do it, but they really made it big.
Yeah.
Which I really appreciate. I love hit markers. Mm-hmm. I know it's not realistic, but they're very helpful for knowing you're hitting what you want to hit.
Especially you got things at if you're going with like an M16 and you're trying to hit something down range really far, it's nice to know you're actually making contact when all you see is a pixel, you know,
from
across the map.
I know. And it's a great franchise. I just feel like they've really they
it needs
need
more
to take,
love. It
they
needs
need
more
to take
love.
They need to take a year or two off and chill.
And
they need
really
to chill out.
Just put the work back into it rather than.
And
they just keep slapping future. Let's make it more future.
Yeah,
more future.
And
that
we've talked about that in the past. That I'm getting tired of the modern and future warfare. I wish they'd go back again, at least for a couple of games.
I'd like to see another World War II one.
Me
again,
too.
Honestly.
Yep. By the way, a Hard Bulldog says that he's from Newark, New Jersey. So
nice,
shout
man.
Out
Thanks
to Newark,
joining.
New Jersey. Thanks for hanging out. But man, I just feel like they need to take a year or two, reassess. What they need to do is take the two studios...
Get their roots back.
Take those two studios and merge them into one and just do a bi-yearly release. Do a really rocking game every 2 years.
Yeah.
They'd make bank. They really would. I mean...
They'd bring me back.
I understand that it's like with Madden, they're making a lot of money every year, but I bet you anything, if they just took their time, did a bi-year... every 2 year release, on a bi-yearly schedule... They would kill every time they came out with it because they'd build up that hype and then people would get excited.
Exactly. People would have time to,
and
it'd
give them time to test it and get everything working and get all those really nice features tested and in.
Yeah, and Assassin's Creed suffering heavily from the same syndrome. You know, everything, it used to be. You know, they didn't have to be in Assassin's Creed.
Well, I mean,
every
look
year.
At Unity. That was a disaster.
It was broken.
It was totally broken.
It wasn't
intrinsically.
Even the
full game. Like, the actual. It was from the ground up was broken. It was flawed fundamentally.
Yeah, exactly. It's just,
and they just.
The greed just takes
They just
too
pumped
much
it
from,
out.
Yeah. It cost the studios too much, I think. But it's hard, though, because. You know, I feel that way personally.
Yeah.
Not forcing that on anybody else.
Right.
But people have to... Someone has to be enjoying it.
Yeah.
Someone has to be, or it wouldn't work.
Right.
You know, because they're clearly able to keep every year pumping these games out.
Yeah.
And they're selling. They're selling copies out the wazoo.
Yeah.
And so I'm wondering, what is it about that... That makes people keep coming back to it.
About the yearly games?
No. What about the game itself keeps people wanting to come back regardless? You know, even though I feel that it's suffering and they're not up to the same standards that they used to be, they keep
Here's my theory. It's comfortable. People don't like change that much. I mean, look at what happens
so
when
it's just
they...
the same game.
Well, look what happens when they introduce... new mechanics and stuff. People are like, well, that's stupid. That's dumb. That's idiotic. I hate that.
It doesn't work like it used to.
Right. Mm. But the problem is that the players are comfortable. So and I'm not saying all players are like this. I'm not saying all gamers are like this. And I'm not saying it's necessarily a bad thing because as humans, we don't like change.
Oh yeah. The brain loves routine.
And there is absolutely nothing wrong with liking a yearly franchise. Mm-hmm. I mean, look at Madden. Look at the NHL. Look at any of the sports franchises. They come out yearly.
The only thing with that I disagree is the sports franchises, I can see a reason for them doing that.
Yeah.
Because each year, the sports team stats change depending on how well they played the previous year. So, it makes sense for them to come out every year because that team didn't play the same
last year.
And
you're absolutely right.
But with Call of Duty...
It's again. I truly just think it's that comfort factor. I think that gamers are just at the point. Hold on a sec. I'm going to turn this down. I was getting some fan feedback in my headphones. I just feel that comfort level is so up there,
so strong
that they can pump out the same game essentially with minor tweaks every year. And not have a complaint, and people just pick it up.
Looks...
Also, you have the competitive scene, which pushes that forward. I mean, if they did this with like Counter-Strike or League of Legends, where they did a release every year, the same thing would happen because people want to play a competitive game and they want to have bragging rights.
Mm-hmm.
It's like that high score table. People want to be on top of that high score table, but instead, you can say, "Oh, I'm a level 50 I'm a prestige 5 with I have every gun unlocked and I have I'm in a clan that is ranked
top
silver
tier,
the thing, and I have I have 3,000 hours in the game and that sort of thing."
Yeah.
So
I wish that we would collectively come together and just
I wish we could.
We deserve more than the same rinse and repeat.
The same thing goes with DLC. I wish that as a community, and it'll never happen because the gaming community is so big and vast. I mean, we're talking at least 100 million people. I mean, at least. You got to realize, worldwide there are millions and millions and millions of gamers. And there are, that includes your grandma and grandpa that play, you know, Facebook games all day. I count them as gamers. Mm-hmm. They're casual gamers. They're not hardcore. They're not gamers in the same exact sense as people who play every major AAA release or every indie title that comes out. Yeah. But, I mean, just as a whole, we need to... And it, again, it'll never happen, but as a whole, we need to come together and say, enough of this. This is BS. Put a stop to this. I'm tired of being taken for a ride. I feel we deserve more than
just the same game with a new skin put on it.
Yeah.
You know what I mean? It's just the same exact thing. And like you were saying with the competitive scene, it makes it easier for that because you don't have to learn a new game. You can use your same tactics you were using for the last 7 games and still be on the top.
Yep.
But I feel like if they remade it and the mechanics were different, I'm not saying it needs to be a fully different game, you know, because games like that are going to function pretty close regardless because it's an FPS. You know,
right.
It's going to, you know, for the most part, you know, run the same kind of, you know, way. But
right.
It'll give newcomers a chance to be competitive.
Yeah.
You know, because they'll start out on the same level as everyone else.
That's what I'm excited about this Dirty Bomb game for, is because everyone starts off at that same level. This is new to everybody.
Mm-hmm.
And that happens with every release of a new IP, but you don't see AAA titles taking those chances because they don't want to invest the money.
Exactly.
Because, I mean, look at how many sequels and reboots of games we're seeing. I mean, even Battlefront is a reboot. The next Mirror's Edge... were Plants vs. Zombies 2.
Yeah, like origin stories.
Yeah,
and some...
Garden Warfare 2, I mean.
Yeah.
I mean, just look at all the games that are coming out with sequels from AAA companies rather than new IPs.
Brand new IP. Which always frustrates me.
It'll always be one of those things. That's my big problem.
They want that golden, you know, opportunity.
Yeah,
to just make
they
the
want
same,
that golden egg that they can just sit on.
Keep
and,
milking.
Yep,
yeah.
They want that philosopher's stone. They want to turn all that coal into gold, you know? Mm-hmm. They just want to keep pumping
it
full.
And just that same one is going to do it every time.
Yep.
Which is frustrating so bad because new IP is what really gets me excited to be a gamer because it's something branching out.
Well, that's what I loved about E3. We saw quite a few new IPs. I mean, like
Great,
No Man's Sky, that one, was it Yarn? Or... Thread? No, Yarn. I think
something
it was Yarn.
Like that. I know which one you're talking about.
Yeah, the one with the shaky dude.
Yeah,
like,
exactly.
This is Yarny, and I came up with the concept of this game when I was camping with my children.
Poor
I
guy,
just peed
man.
My pants. You
Poor
know?
Guy.
I feel so bad for that dude. But
another one, too, is that, what was it? It's like, I think it's called like Horizon New Dawn. Or
oh, yeah.
Like T-Rex
that looks so
robot.
Cool. That's beautiful looking.
Oh
I mean,
gosh.
Dude, that game, regardless, I think is going to do well.
Yeah,
I mean, unless the story completely blows,
yeah,
it's going to do all right.
And it's just so refreshing to see new IP.
So Jerboff says, do you like Mortal Kombat or do you prefer Street Fighter? I'm not much of a fighter guy.
Take this one,
yeah, well, I'm not a huge fighter dude. Myself, I like fighters in the sense that they're fun to play casually, like against AI and stuff, or in arcades. I love playing
on
in arcades.
Low difficulty.
Yeah, I'm just not that. I mean, much like hack and slashes, it just makes my hands tired, and I can only do it for so long, and I just get frustrated. Like Super Smash Brothers, I think
if I
were to pick a fighting game, I'm sorry, I'd have to pick Super Smash.
Yeah,
I mean, hands down. But if we're excluding Smash. And we're just sticking to Mortal Kombat and Street Fighter.
The traditional fighters.
I mean, I'm on the fence. I like both a lot. I mean, I love Mortal Kombat for the gore and the over-the-top insanity, like the X-rays and the fatalities and, like, way back the babalities and the animalities and all that.
And the
stuff.
Friendship ones. Oh. Just, like, take a... Those were awesome.
Those were great. Stuff like that. I love Street Fighter for the characters, and I love Mortal Kombat for the... Just the insanity.
Yeah.
That's... So I can play either all day. I like them both. I just... I'm not a big fan of fighters in general. I'm not good at them. That's my problem. I'm really bad at them, actually.
I'd have to agree with you there. If I had to pick one that I liked more, I'd probably have to say Street Fighter.
Yeah?
I'd like the atmosphere and the characters
more.
Well,
it's less gloomy.
Yeah,
and
exactly.
I mean, I know they have blood and you're kicking people in the face, and it's just as violent. I mean, it's not just as violent. I mean, Mortal Kombat is hella violent.
Mortal Kombat to me is more for a shock factor.
Yes, it's always been there to push the envelope, just like Doom.
Yeah, exactly.
Just like Doom. Mm-hmm. I mean, Doom is there, exists to push the envelope, to make people go, that's indecent. Yeah, and then have the gaming industry go, well, F you, we're going to do this anyways. Mm-hmm. Because you can't control us. This is art. This is what we do. Mm-hmm. And I love that.
Yeah.
That's why I always will have great respect for Mortal Kombat, even if the game is crap. Mm-hmm. As long as they keep pushing that envelope
don't
as much as they can.
Tell them it's
and
too
don't
much.
Let people mm-hmm. boss them around. Just like Team Ninja. Mm-hmm. With they had a lot of those people. There were a lot of folks telling them that, well, the boob jiggle is too much. The boob jiggle is too much. And they were like, well, we make games for our customers and they like it.
Yeah.
So we're going to keep doing it. So tough.
Exactly.
And I really respect that. And mm-hmm. I mean, it has always done the same thing. Id Software has always done that where they're just like, and so is Rockstar, where they're mm-hmm. just like, we're going to make the game we want to make.
Yeah.
If you want to ban us from stores in Australia,
by all means.
Tough. We're still going to make this game. And mm-hmm. it's going to sell or it's not going to sell, but I don't care. And then the folks who make Postal, they got rated adults only.
Oh, wow.
Yeah, which is a death sentence.
Yeah.
But they still sell. Mm-hmm. And they're like, no, we're going to do it. We're going to make this game, and we do it because we love the craft and we love the art mm-hmm. and we love our customers.
Yeah.
And that makes me a lifelong customer regardless. I mean, that's like one of those things that even if I think your game sucks, I'm still more willing to put down the money for it.
Just for what you stand
for.
Than
I would be for a company that makes this like Care Bear, fluffy, touchy-feely game.
Yeah.
I'll pass.
I'm with you too on the same thing that I'm terrible at fighting games.
Yeah.
So I don't play them that much.
Right.
But I did buy Street Fighter V when it was it Street Fighter V or 4?
I think 5 was the most recent.
Okay, well then it must have been 4. I did buy it just because, like you said, they're fun to play against the computer. But I cannot, for the life of me, be good at those games.
I'm awful.
I don't understand the combos or anything like that. I love to set it on like where you just like press two buttons and you can pull off a Hadouken and stuff like that, or the Ultimate Turbos, and I feel like, yeah, I'm amazing.
Yeah, I'm not the kind of person that'll go buy one of the game pads,
the super
the arcade pads, the arcade sticks.
Yeah,
I'm not one of those. But
I do like. I would have to say I like Street Fighter
now.
More.
If I got to pick any fighter game though, I think I'd pick Soul Calibur.
Really?
I love Soul Calibur. I love Soul Calibur. And just because the characters are so enigmatic and all that, I mean, you just got such interesting characters like Sophitia and all that stuff. And I mean, they're just
remember when
and
they
Ivy
did, like, the
and
Star
Voldo.
Wars characters in there.
That
you
was so
as
weird. You could
Yoda
play as a
and
or
Darth
a,
Vader.
Garen, I think you could play as Garen Malik, Starkiller as well in one.
Could
of
you?
Them.
Yeah, I remember
yeah,
you could play as Vader and Yoda. And
yeah,
because
you
like
could do. I think you could do Garen Malik versus Vader.
Because
he was like a super secret character unlocked. Because
it
was around the time
Nintendo, you could play as
Link. Yeah, it was around the time that Force Unleashed came out. Yeah. And so they were really pushing that hard, so they teamed up with the Soul Calibur guys. I remember that pretty distinctly.
And like you were saying, if I did have to pick a fighter out of all the fighters that I would like, Smash Brothers.
Smash Bros.
Smash
amazing.
Brothers I can play always.
I give it mad props. I will always respect Smash Brothers as the king of fighting games. I think it always will. I think just because
it's the most accessible, I feel
like.
Yeah,
because
as well.
It's characters that everyone knows. Mm-hmm. I mean,
and it just the way
you don't
it
have
plays
to learn a story.
Super difficult.
Yeah, you don't have to learn a story. You don't have to like get involved with a character. You don't have to like have any real investment in a character. You're just like, oh god, Mario's kicking Link's butt. That's awesome.
Yeah.
You know, it's it's ridiculous.
And there's not it's not so advanced to where it's daunting when you get in there.
Right.
There's really not a lot of moves that characters can pull off.
Right.
But there's enough depth to where you can really do some, you know, get deep into a character and really master that character.
Yeah.
Without having to be, you know, super pro and know all the button combinations.
Yes. Yeah.
Like, I can never, when I pick up a fighting game like Street Fighter, when you go, you know how you can go like the command list? No idea what anything that means.
Oh, yeah.
No,
I'm just
like.
It's
not like B and A and X. It's
well, the
a fist
the controls
with a foot
are
in,
so simple and easy. And it's just, it's a fighter game. It's an everyman's fighter game. You can get as serious or as casual as you want. And
exactly.
Nobody's really going to judge you.
Yeah.
I mean, seriously, because I play that game, and anytime someone challenges me to it, I'm like, I don't really play it that seriously. I really suck. And they're like, no biggie. And then you still have an okay chance unless they're like pro level.
Yeah.
So it's fun because even if you get, you can still get lucky in it.
Huge roster too.
Oh yeah. Massive. There's so many characters. I love that. That's awesome. That never gets boring.
Yeah.
And the addition of items you can do with items. I love playing with items. I'm not like Final Destination Fox only, no items type thing. Are you? I hate you so much. Don't be that guy, George.
I'm only that guy if someone is like really wants to fight me to test my abilities. Then I'm Samus, no items, 5 stock, son. We're shutting it down.
Yeah, 5 stock. Fox, Final Destination, no items, 5 stock.
Exactly. That
F you.
But if
you're that guy,
with,
George.
If we're playing with a bunch of people and we're just playing.
Yeah, if you're just screwing around. That's what I love, though, is you can play casual. And with items, anyone can win. It's anybody's game. And I love
and
that.
And I really do.
Because you can get really mad and like something blows you up. You're like, God, I can't believe that. You know, and even vets with items can get screwed.
That's what I love, too. Because with items, I feel like it's almost on the same level as Mario Kart. Like, you can be losing the entire
and then you get that blue shell or
the
lightning.
And then you can get first place. It's just
it's great.
You can last for all 17 laps, and then and you're one dude's just owning first place.
That's
the whole
so
thing.
Right.
Lightning bolt and, like, the blue shell, and you're
and
in first place.
And it's just like,
GG. Why?
GG.
You know, but like you said, one item can change the whole fight.
That's right.
You can own somebody, you know, from getting a bomb.
Oh,
or,
for sure.
You know,
for sure. It
and
makes
I
a
like
huge
the addition
difference.
Of the Smash Balls now, too. Because up to...
I don't know what that is. Oh, in the supers that you can get in Smash
Bros.
Yeah,
like everybody gets like their
own cool.
super move.
Yeah,
you get
that's
that
pretty cool.
Thing.
And everybody fights over it. That's pretty awesome.
Because up to like GameCube, they didn't have anything like that. And
I think the first one was Brawl. Yeah, Brawl was the first one that brought that in.
At first, I hated them. But I've started to get used to them now, too.
So which one of the Super Smash Brothers do you like the most?
Samus.
No, the games.
Oh,
that's not a game.
GameCube.
George,
GameCube's
not a game.
My favorite.
I gotta say...
The new one's pretty good, though. Let me the new one's almost up to the GameCube one. It's just the Wii Brawl nerfed my character so hard.
I'm,
she's
slow.
Pace.
Yeah, I remember that. I was like, she's
slow.
Too slow. What the hell?
Samus used to be, for the GameCube version, you could be about as fast as Fox or Falcon. No problem.
That's what I loved about Samus. I used her all the time because
and they nerfed
anytime
her so
someone used Fox, I was at least a decent counter.
Yeah.
I could deal
with
it.
And then now
that up
they
B was like,
speed again.
The spin move was
solid.
Amazing.
Yeah.
I'll always be partial to the N64 version.
Yeah?
Yeah, dude, I loved it. And it's actually so balanced that it's just nobody has a real advantage, to be honest. I mean, I think Fox is a little overpowered, but
that
even then,
to
the
be
controls.
Consistent through
the controls. The controls are so simple, though. Mm-hmm. Like, because the N64 controller just doesn't have that much.
Yeah.
That it's so well balanced, I think, that it's hard to cheese.
No one's really.
It's really
too
hard
OP,
to cheese. I mean, there's a couple of characters that can cheese pretty hard. I hate cheesing. Don't be that guy either.
I'm not that guy.
Yeah, I don't like it.
But yeah, it's a lot of fun. Smash is one of my favorite games. I still have people still come over, you want to bring over your GameCube and play Smash? I was like, yeah. I do.
Heck yeah. Do bears crap in the woods?
Exactly.
Yes
they do.
I'm
and they
in.
Play Smash while they're crapping.
That's right. I'll play Smash while I'm crapping all day.
So good. I'm glad they didn't nerf my character though anymore.
So, Mr. Nelson just said something in another language, but thanks for hanging out and stopping by.
Yes.
I think that might be
your question,
Swedish?
Yes.
Maybe Swedish?
I don't know what it means. I don't even know.
I apologize
I'll
don't
say
speak
yes,
it.
Though.
But I'm glad you came by. I mean, we both are. It's cool to have
thanks
you.
Thanks for visiting, man.
Yeah, rock on. You're awesome.
We're glad to have you.
Everybody here is awesome. You
You're
guys
all
are
the best. We love
Get
you.
Out of my head.
I am your head.
What?
That's Get out of my brain, Charles.
Bye, Felicia.
Oh, my God. Oh, my God. I can't believe you took it there. I can't believe you took it there.
So, Hard Bulldog 37 said two things. First, he said World at War while we were talking about Call of Duty. World at War was really good.
World
that was
War.
The World War II one.
Yeah.
That we really loved.
Oh, my
loved.
Gosh. Heck I love that one.
That's a good one.
We
it's one of my
killing
favorites.
That.
Yeah, dude. We were rocking that. That and Battlefield Bad Company 2. Dude, I got
two
a question.
Two of, like, the best ones.
Two of, I think, the best shooters that
we
have
the most fun with
I think two
two
of the best shooters that I have ever played in terms of Bad Company 2 for its scale and balance, because all the classes were just so...
In sniping.
Oh, sniping.
The best thing in the world. Bullet drop, I love you.
The bullet drop in that was so good, because, like, you could just, like, nail people from across the map, and they would just have no idea where you were. You're just like,
I love being able to just call out, too, how many notches on the sniper.
I did that in Battlefield 4. There was a sniper rifle that's like a pickup. Like, you can pick it up. Like, it's like a... There's, like, pickups in some areas.
Like, huge ones.
Like a huge 50 cal.
Yeah.
You can't, like, normally get it, I guess, in normal gameplay.
You can't carry it in to the match.
So I pick it up, right? And I'm on this rooftop, and across the map are, like, a bunch of enemy soldiers moving in.
Does your bullet drop? Okay.
It's nowhere near like it was in Bad Company, but I fired around. I mean, this bullet is like
size of a golf ball.
Like, it's massive, and like you just watch it, and just like it just arcs gracefully, and then I missed. I missed, and then I popped one, and it just hit this dude in the back, like in the back, dead square, and he just insta-killed.
Is it one shot?
Yep. Nice. And I actually have that as one of our highlights on here.
Sweet.
And oh my god, dude, I cackled like a witch, dude. I was just like, I can't believe it. Then I got knifed.
Oh, that's the worst.
It's okay. Like, I got the kill, though. That's all I care about. Like, it's like I just want to use this gun and get a kill from across the map, and I will feel
best
accomplished.
Feeling ever.
And there's just those moments. I love those moments in games that just make you feel so. That's the kind of stuff that nowadays still revitalizes my love for games.
Mm-hmm.
Like, I was playing Dirty Bomb, and I went like 25 and like 11 or something ridiculous.
Wow, you didn't. Good job.
Yeah, I was just running around. I would drop a proximity mine, see a guy,
so
gun him down.
So you play as proxy.
She's my main. She's my main character, and I have a pretty good card for her. And I would just run around, drop proximity mines, and just use my shotgun and just gun people down. Mm-hmm. And like when they're down, they're on the ground, and then you have to finish them or they can get revived.
Yeah.
And then you finish them by pulling out your knife and stabbing them. So it was like, boom, knife, stab, boom, knife, stab. And I was just running around the map doing that. And it was intense. And I couldn't find the footage afterwards because I played for like 5 hours and I couldn't remember when I did it. I didn't want to watch 5 hours of my own footage. I'm not going to listen to myself for 5 hours. That's annoying. But it was awesome. And it's those things that really just re-energize me. Yeah. And I have a feeling I'm going to have a lot of those moments in both Battlefront in Fallout 4. And they come out a week apart.
Do they?
I'm pretty sure. Jesus, when does Fallout 4 come out again?
It was like the 10th?
November 10th?
I think it might be the 10th.
And Battlefront is the 17th, so yeah, it's a week apart.
I'm really excited about Battlefront.
So yeah, it is a week apart from each other, and I am super excited about Battlefront 2, Battlefront as well. It's not Battlefront 2, it's Battlefront as well.
How are you going to put time into those two, man? Those are like two heavy hitters.
Here's the thing, is when I get tired of Fallout, I'll switch over to Battlefront.
But is that going
to
happen?
It will. I always get burnout, dude. I got to take it in chunks, you know? One day I'll... Because I do, on Thursdays, I do RPG night. I play an RPG, and I'm juggling like four RPGs right now.
Oh my gosh.
Including a classic SNES one. Uncharted Waters 2 New Horizons, bro.
They have a tabletop for that?
No.
Oh, you're playing the actual game. Oh, you said Thursday. I thought you said Tuesday.
Tuesdays are my tabletop.
Yeah,
RPGs
that's what I thought you were talking about.
My tabletop group.
What?
No. I'm doing
tabletop?
No, I'm doing Thursday nights I play an RPG. I play at least an RPG for a couple hours.
Okay.
Every other night is like open. So at least I'll be playing Fallout 4 on Thursdays. Probably a lot more than that the first week.
Yeah.
And the same thing with Battlefront is I'll probably play a ton of Battlefront right up until I get a little burnout on it. And then I'll stop myself for a couple of days and I'll come back to it when I'm kind of re-energized. What? Wife's probably home.
Oh, okay.
Or else they knocked the trash over. I don't know yet.
Oh, okay.
Dog's getting into stuff. Anyway, so... Yeah, so I'm pretty stoked about both. They're both going to be amazing.
I saw some screenshots of like 4K Battlefront.
Oh my god. I think my new video card can push 4K. Probably at reduced settings.
That's not
but
fair.
I don't have a 4K monitor, so it doesn't matter.
Yeah.
So I just played a 1920 by 1080 on a 22-inch screen.
Yeah, you're like
I'm right there anyways. Yeah. I don't need it to be that,
it's still
like that.
Stunning though, man. It is like that's like the first time I've actually felt like it was a movie, seeing
a
game
dude.
Played, it was just
and
like,
how long was the gameplay? Like almost 30 minutes or something?
I think around that. And it was just like,
dude, it's so
every
buttery.
Second, I'm just like,
it is so smooth.
Yeah,
and this isn't finished yet. It's not released. Oh,
and
I'm
even
still,
the low atmosphere.
I haven't even pre-ordered it yet. I'm waiting for them to come out with a collector's edition.
I'm surprised they haven't like announced some like
they
Uber,
have a they have
super.
A deluxe edition. Which has like digital goodies, and it's only for PS4 and Xbox One. You can't get the deluxe edition on PC yet.
Wait, what does it come with?
Just extra guns. unlocked right away.
So it's not like DLC or anything, just purely you get a few extra guns?
Yeah, I think you get like guns early or something. I don't know. Mm. And there's a couple, you get like a digital art book and things in the game, stuff like that.
I don't want to, yeah. I would rather a real physical art book.
So Mr. Nelson said, hey guys, how are you? Nice stream, easy to listen to. Thank you so much.
Thank you.
Appreciate it.
Thanks
he said,
for watching.
What about Mass right. Effect Andromeda? What about that? So, you know,
I'm a big fan of Mass Effect. Dude, I have been since the beginning.
BioWare is awesome. I mean, yes. they've had missteps, they've had hiccups,
mm-hmm.
but Inquisition, Dragon Age Inquisition is insanely good.
Mm-hmm.
They did a really good job.
Yet.
But it got such good reviews, and my boss at work has put in, and I mean he has a daughter, he is super busy, he like works all the time, and he mm-hmm. does all this stuff. He's put 120 hours into it and beat it.
Wow.
It took him 120 hours to beat the game.
That's amazing.
That's legit. And I was like, well, it couldn't have been bad because you put 120 hours into it. And he's
yeah.
like, no, it was good. It was really mm-hmm. good. And I really respect his opinion on it because he doesn't play like a massive amount of games,
mm-hmm.
but the games he plays are
he
usually
puts time
pretty
into,
epic
yeah.
games, and he gets pretty thorough with. And I'm mm-hmm. like, woo, I believe you. And
yeah.
my wife's played it. I played a little bit of it. It's really good. So I'm spitting all over my pop filter. I'm so excited.
Excited
to have
yeah.
it. I'm just like foaming at the mouth. I'm just like, I'm really excited about it. I mean,
mm-hmm.
I think BioWare's really knocking it out of the park again. I mean, they did it for a while, right up until Mass Effect 1 came out, and then 2 came out, and it was good. That was around when they got scooped up by EA,
mm-hmm.
and then 3 had problems.
Yeah.
And then they
still
came out with Dragon
though.
Age. They came out with Dragon Age
enjoyable.
2 around a little before that. That had problems. We're going to say there's room for improvement. And now that Inquisition's out, it's good. I think Andromeda's going to be rocking.
Yeah.
We haven't seen a lot of it yet.
Mm,
I think it's going to be.
I haven't seen.
I'm excited.
I love that universe. I just
I'm,
love.
Well,
the
I'm
Mass
excited
Effect
to
universe.
See more of the universe without
yeah.
Shepard. I want to see. I would love to see the world without those. What are they? The Reavers or whatever.
Yeah, the Reavers.
Yeah,
or Reapers.
Reapers. Thank
yeah.
you. Yeah, I get all these games mixed up. I've been playing so many lately. But yeah, the Reapers. I want to see it without them. I want to see a war between like the Krogans and the humans or something. Wouldn't that
dude,
be legit?
That would be. Krogans apparently though like devastate when they go out because that's why they had
oh,
to
I know.
Shut down the race.
That's
the,
right. That's
the,
right. And I mean
the genophage it was called.
Yeah, the genophage. Yeah,
yeah.
That was pretty cool.
They just like start once they yep. start, it's they're breeding like rabbits. So they had to shut them down. But
what is it? What is
rich...
it? I am the very model of a scientist, Solarian.
Oh my! What's his name?
I can't even remember. I love that guy though.
Oh my god.
Mr. Nelson says Mass Effect 2 was definitely the best so far, and I tend to agree. It was really good. 3 had its upsides. The multiplayer, the cooperative,
that was
its saving grace,
I
think.
Serious amount of
fun. I think that was
that.
Its saving grace. I
yeah.
really do. Unfortunately, they added a bunch of crap to it and then we just never played it again
yeah,
because
we kind of just dropped off.
Well,
cuz
we had so many games to play and we still do.
I did like the effect that how they added you like built up the currency and you bought like the chests that
yeah.
could have drops and it actually could lock on.
Oh, I love that. And
characters
and that's similar to how like Dirty Bomb does it a little bit and stuff like that. I love
the cards.
I really like that style.
Mm-hmm.
I really do. It gives a little bit of randomness to it, so not everyone has the best thing right away.
It's more luck of the draw rather
right.
than you just paid.
And I love RNGs. I know a lot of people hate them.
You
but
could buy credits, right? I believe.
Yeah,
in,
I think
yeah.
you could buy credits, and it was like a little mini purchase, which was I think another
yeah.
misstep. I'm not a big fan of people buying credits and stuff, especially
but
if
that
you
was
pay,
just to
but
get,
especially
it was still the random crates though.
But especially after you spend $60 on it, that's kind of
yeah.
crappy. Like if it was free to play, yes, all the way. But yeah, I'm not a.
But at least they weren't so expensive, not to buy with money, but I mean with the credits you earn from actually you know beating the rounds.
Yeah,
it wasn't so terrible. You know, that you couldn't just wait, you know, play
yeah.
a few rounds. Because we did that, but every once in a while we would buy, you know, enough to get, like, maybe one of the premium
right.
credit packs. But I wasn't,
it took
I think
us
maybe,
forever,
like,
though.
$5 I dropped into that max.
Yeah, I think you know, I think I did the same thing.
Yeah.
I wasn't a fan
and
of that, though. I felt dirty
plenty,
afterwards.
Plenty,
I had to go take a shower.
Plenty out of it, though, nonetheless.
Mr. Nelson says, Mass Effect 3 went too much drama RPG and too much fetching and walking, not much shootouts. Not a lot of action. And he said 2 was a real big step forward in gameplay, 3 in graphics. And you're absolutely right.
Mm-hmm.
I mean, that's
yeah.
that is a great summation. I mean, because they were trying so hard to shoehorn in the ending. exactly. That they went really heavy on the storyline.
Most of them talking to everybody.
Yeah,
rather than
and
fighting.
They were trying to tie up loose ends, and they botched the ending, and they really screwed up on that stuff. Yeah. I mean, they really could have taken that a completely different direction. And
I think that comes to another thing of being rushed too.
Well, that's just it. Is I feel like EA
that's what really affects
EA
people.
Now has a new CEO. I mean, not super new. I mean, it's been a while, but
yeah, newer.
Yeah, their CEO is putting more emphasis on actually making good games, which needs to happen for EA. They really
need to cut.
They have.
The
they've been doing great.
Yeah,
they've
much
been doing
better.
Great.
You just got to cut out the deadline, man. That really makes the quality suffer.
I agree. It's pretty bad. So I'm really looking forward to seeing their new games. I really am. I'm looking forward to it. I think it's going to be good. I'm just so excited to see more of that universe without being Shepard.
Watch Dogs type situation.
I don't want to be. I know this sounds weird, but I don't want to be the savior of the universe every freaking time.
Yeah. Mm-hmm.
Maybe the savior of a race or a planet or something. Make it like really feel like you've made a difference. When you're saving the universe, you don't feel like you've made that big of a difference, in my opinion.
But are you gonna feel like you made enough of a difference to be worth playing
if it stops a war or three planets? Like
if
it stops the annihilation of a planet specifically, like you're working towards a planet, sure, but I mean the entire galaxy is
one planet is enough.
I mean
for
it
you
has its
like
place. I'm not saying but for me, I would just prefer to feel I feel like they could really focus the story a little bit more instead of making it this
doesn't
massive,
need to be so vast as long
it's
as it's
so vast. And I mean I want to explore the universe, but I want to explore more of the culture. I want to visit a planet and really see how they live day to day and all this stuff, like just really live
their
lives.
So that wouldn't be too mundane, you think?
No, because I mean that's kind of how Dragon Age is. Mm-hmm. I mean you learn a lot about specific races and how things are. Like there's the alienage with all the elves in it, and they're treated like scum and slaves and servants.
Yeah.
And you've got the Dalish elves who have their own story and their own language, and they're like mystical and more into like magic and nature, and they live off the land. And then I mean there's just so much, and I mean there's
so
a lot
learning,
to Mass Effect.
So you feel like learning about the world itself,
it's really important to me. Yeah. I mean that's to me though. I mean a lot gameplay is important. Important too, don't get me wrong, but in games like that, to me the lore is extremely important. That's why I like Star Wars so much, why I like Star Trek so much, why I like Dragon Age as much as I do D&D. I mean I just love I love huge vast lore and stories and a lot of places, a lot of things to play with, you know.
I feel like those could too go hand in hand if they put enough time into it.
And you're right, they do. I mean, look at Dragon Age Inquisition, look at Dragon Age, the first Dragon Age and Awakening. Look at Mass Effect 1. They did a little bit, like they didn't get that was before it got like well, it did get pretty serious
have to do
in that.
One
but
or the other, I do.
They shouldn't have to pick.
Yeah.
But in some cases they do.
That big, you know, saving more than just, you know, one planet. I like being able to save,
it has
I'm
its
saving
place,
everybody.
For sure, it has its place. I mean, look at Star Wars where they bring down the big bad guy, the Emperor, who is the ultimate evil in the universe at the time. That's saving the universe. And that felt pretty accomplished because you have, like, an overarching villain. And I'm not saying Mass Effect doesn't. I'm just saying that...
Their villain was the race.
I can get into it either way. I just my preference. I think
you prefer.
Is, I love an overarching story that focuses on a main villain that you just can't seem to kill, or you defeat all of his minions building up to that. I mean, I really like that trope. I really do.
Yeah.
It's just one of the things that I like. But I'm good with anything. I mean, with Bioshock Infinite, you're working up to, you know, freeing Elizabeth and stopping Comstock, and that's the big bad, and you work the whole game trying to, you know, defeat Comstock and get out of there.
Yeah.
And you learn a lot about the story, and there's this beautiful story around it, and it all kind of interlinks.
Deep.
It's very deep and all that. So it's just, it's very interesting to me because it's very focused on that one end goal. And I'm, again, saving the universe is an end goal, but it's so big.
You just feel overwhelmed.
Yes, that's the word. It's overwhelming and just very almost oppressive how big it is. It's just like you do feel like you have the weight of the universe on you in some cases. And I don't know if I like that feeling.
That's sort of how I feel. Not
it's
in
stressful.
The sense
I don't
that,
like stress
yeah,
when I'm playing games.
Not in the sense of, you know, like it's, you know, saving everyone is looming on me, but that overwhelming feeling is how I feel in games like Skyrim and stuff like that, because that there's just too much to do, which some people find that's amazing, you know, because right. they can get literally endless hours out of this. But then I feel like I'm not accomplishing anything because it's too much to do.
You do get to do those small victories, which some people do find very fulfilling. And I do in some cases. Like, working my way up from the bottom to the top of, like, the Mercenaries or the Fighters Guild or the Thieves Guild or something.
Yeah.
That's like almost a game in its own, you know, and it's beautifully written and it's interesting and it's its own kind of world. And that's another world, the Elder Scrolls, that's really well fleshed out that I love. So I understand where you're coming from, because you can feel overwhelmed by having too much to do in the macro sense, the micro sense, the small scale. You prefer that macro, that large scale.
Yeah, exactly. I know what I'm doing, and this is my goal. But with games like that, I just feel
you've got so many goals.
I can't. I'm not making any progress because there's just endless amounts to do. You know, say I complete 40 quests. That's a drop in the bucket compared to the scheme of everything you can do.
Yes.
It's just endless, 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 and I never feel accomplished.
Yeah.
Like, I really made a difference in what I'm doing because it's endless. There's no beating.
And Mr. Nelson says, I don't think Mass Effect universe has an overall villain. The universe is so big there can't be one.
Mm-hmm.
And that's just it for me, is that, like, the overall villain is kind of the Reapers, but kind of not, and they just...
There's other villains muddled. For other areas.
Right, it gets muddled to me.
That's the
big
villain.
But there's so much evil in the world that it's all aiming to destroy pretty much everything. You know, like everybody that everything you love is gonna die.
Yeah.
And that's where I think my problem comes in. Like, in Halo, at first it's the Covenant, and then it's the Flood, and you're trying to stop the Flood, and that's your goal. And your goal shifts, but there's not so much that you can really focus in on that one goal, and your goal is your goal. And in the first Halo, it was, you know, your goal is destroy the Halo ring so the Flood doesn't spread.
Yeah, exactly.
And that's just how it is. So,
speaking of the Flood, I really miss the Flood.
Me too.
The Flood was
an
amazing
enemy. They got rid of them
enemy.
For the what are they called? The Protheans.
Protheans.
Yeah, I didn't like those very much. But that was
such
4.
A unique enemy. It just reminded
me
of...
Dude, that's Halo 4. 343 just shafted it, and it really upset me. I mean, it was such a good
story.
Did
Halo 3 still have the Flood?
Yeah, I think so.
Are you sure? Because I felt like it ended pretty early.
They didn't have Protheans.
Yeah, no, I think it was just Covenant.
That's fine.
I think it had
Flood.
Had the Flood because
you had to,
like,
finish the fight.
Flood,
that was the story. Finish
like
the fight.
Flood, like King Big Giant Flood thing.
Yep,
that's right. Yeah.
Hard Bulldog 37 said, "Gears of War for the Xbox One. Gears of 4."
I had a lot of fun with the Gears of War series when it first was coming out for like 360. It was very new and fresh, and then they really mastered the cover system.
Oh, the cover
that
system
was
in that was
like
the best.
Unheard of. And
wasn't
was
that
just,
all Cliffy B?
Yeah,
Cliffy B. That dude's a genius.
It was such a dark, just gritty universe, which I love.
Everything
was dark. It was just grim. And
well, and you just, that was the universe. You
and
know?
It was just,
I mean,
like
that
this
was,
raspy, you know.
The world was already effed.
Yeah.
And you're just
like,
there
you're
trying,
just trying
to contain.
Survive your next day of this crap storm that
That's
is
right.
this world.
Yeah,
you know?
For sure.
There was no beating this enemy. There's you trying to live. That was it. You know, and the chainsaw gun.
Oh,
what?
So cool.
Like, holy mackerel.
Oh, my gosh. Dude.
Incredible. When
the
I
coolest.
First was just like, and cut a dude in half, it's like, yep.
Oh, the blood spray onto the camera and everything.
Yep.
Oh.
What was it called?
The
Lancer.
Lancer.
Yeah.
It was the Lancer, yeah. So good.
Oh, my gosh.
That game series was fantastic, and I'm very excited they're continuing it.
They went a lot of weird ways towards
though.
The second one. Yeah,
I didn't play 3, so I'm not too sure.
I remember, like, you were playing... Marcus Fenix was
Fenix,
the main
yeah.
guy. And
then
I think the second one you played Phoenix.
And then you played Dom in the third, right?
I think
or was
in the
he
second one,
the
you, it was my you got to play as Phoenix, and then maybe Dom, like, midway.
Yeah.
I know, spoiler, Dom dies, but...
Yeah.
And then there was like this one where you played as whatever the spiky haired guy was. I can't remember what it was. He reminded me of
Coltrane. Was it Coltrane?
No, that's the burly
Coltrane.
He's awesome.
He's cool. I liked
him.
What
is the guy's name? He reminded me of like Johnny Cage almost.
Oh,
you know
I can't remember his name.
He had,
I know
like,
who you're
his
talking
own
about
game.
Though. Yeah,
and then
that was a flop.
Yeah, and then now I don't know what's really happening with the series. I don't know who you play as or, and I never played the one where he played as Johnny Cage.
Yeah.
But, I don't know if Marcus Fenix dies, because he doesn't die in the second one.
No. I don't really know. I don't remember. Yeah, I just don't remember. I haven't played the Gears series.
I remember
in a
with
long
the Johnny
time.
Cage guy, it was like a prequel almost, like before they got together as their like yeah. final group or yep. whatever. But I don't know what happened to Marcus.
Yeah.
Fun game though.
Yeah, was
they
a great
really,
game.
They really nailed the cover system and really
oh,
brought
for
it
sure.
to the forefront to
oh,
where
for sure.
in blind firing just like over
oh,
the
so
top
cool.
without looking.
Yeah.
Sweet.
It was perfection in that game.
I never played or liked the I played the multiplayer, but I never really played it. Didn't really like it. Wasn't my cup
right.
of tea.
Yeah, I was really bad at it and I kept getting owned, so I got a little fed up with it.
Yeah, but fun universe and
yeah,
I
cool
really
universe.
Liked the characters. It was
yeah.
really fun.
So, Mr. Nelson said, I think it's pretty F. There's no more space RPGs. RPGs are mainly focused on fantasy and magic. Not that it's a bad thing, but I'd like to see more space settings.
No Man's Sky?
You know...
No Man's Sky.
Is that an RPG? I thought it was
you
a space sim.
You,
but
you
it's,
get
it's,
stats
so it,
for your weapons. And
I guess it's more of a space sim action RPG combo, a little bit.
Yeah.
But space sims are more about like upgrading
it's not,
and
space
skills.
Sims are more Elite Dangerous to me.
Yeah.
This is less more
but this
arcade-y
is an arcade-y
than,
space
yeah.
sim, yeah.
It's not quite a simulator.
I find it like it's similar to how we are with shooters. It like has that like wibbly wobbly, goes more towards one side, towards the yeah. other. So like we're on fantasy settings. We were on fantasy settings a while back and then it feigned over to space RPGs for a while
because mm-hmm.
I think there were a lot for a little bit. I can't remember specifically, but
I
like KOTOR. I mean, there were a lot during like the early 2000s. There were a few that came out.
Yeah, I can't remember any. I'm so terrible at remembering what title names they are.
I mean, there were quite a few. If I know there were a few. I just honestly can't remember either. But I know there were some, and. I think we're on the backswing towards fantasy again.
Yeah, I feel like we're on the tip of a house and we're just one way
true.
Or the other.
It's true. Well, we're seeing with the new Dungeons & Dragons edition came out. I feel like whenever Dungeons & Dragons comes out with a new edition, we see a lot of fantasy RPGs because they kind of like utilize...
They get
inspired
by that. Yeah,
inspired by that. And I truly think that's the case when a really... big RPG system comes out, like the Dragon Age tabletop is really good. When that came out, I know that they came out with some other stuff too, some other fantasy RPGs around that time as well. When Dragon Age 2 came out, I think it was something like that, or it was like halfway between 2 and Inquisition. And I mean, I just feel like tabletop RPGs do a lot of inspiration for
yeah.
video games.
Well, like he was saying, he's looking for the space. No Man's Sky. They say it's an RPG themselves, the developers. You know,
yeah.
So I'm gonna. There's a lot of. It's not.
It's gonna
RP,
be a mix.
It's not
I
a
think.
Deep
RPG.
RPG you know,
light.
Exactly.
Mixed with space sim light.
Yeah. And
crossover.
If you
hybrid.
Haven't seen it, get on it because
yeah.
no loading between surface.
It's
and
gonna
space.
Be amazing.
I'm all about it.
Jerboss says that he's got to go. See you, Jerboss. Thanks for hanging out, buddy.
Thanks for hanging out, man. It's good seeing.
All right. So
should we probably crack into
yeah,
this?
Yeah. So we're gonna break into this Japan crate.
Let's move this.
Again, we are not paid by anybody, though we wish we were. This just came... they actually sent me two this time around, unintentionally.
One.
And I told them about it. I didn't get a response, so I assume it's okay if I keep it. Thanks, Japan Crate. You guys are awesome. And I'm going to be sending them this video so that they know. I did send them a tweet and said, hey, you sent me an extra one. I didn't get a response.
The
so,
chances of them asking for the back, I think, are probably zero.
Especially since it's open, they don't know what I've done with the candy.
Yeah, and plus,
who knows where
I think
been.
They're not really losing that much for one.
So this
crate.
One, this is the premium crate. It comes with a drink and a whole
it's
bunch of candy.
Bucks.
It's $30. 2-day shipping in the U.S. It's pretty awesome.
Can we? I think this is kind of blocking.
Is it? Okay. So
we
here,
move
here's
it
what
towards me
do.
More.
Here's what we're gonna here we do. Go. So it comes with a little book nowadays, and it goes through all the candies,
we go.
And we're gonna dip into some of these candies before we. Before we hop off today, because we're in a very Japanese mood, we're not going to do the kits. It comes with two kits. Kits are like do-it-yourself
you
candies.
Like
mix you mix things
together
and like put them in the freezer for a while or something like that.
Oh, you
that.
Have to put them in the freezer?
Some of them you do, some you don't.
Okay.
It depends. Like I think this one you put in the fridge. This is a kit. This actually, this book it comes with actually explains everything as to what everything does. So, let me go ahead and find the right page here. It's got a little cartoon. All right, here we go. So, let's go ahead and start with this. This thing is called the Mackin Gummy. It's a hand gummy shaped after rock, paper, or scissors. And it's either cola or grape.
What do we got?
in one of three poses. It looks like it's grape.
No, I mean, what pose are we in?
We can't really tell.
Oh, okay. Let me check it out scissors. Before you crack it.
It's scissors. It's scissors.
I just look at the package.
It's definitely scissors.
Yeah.
So, this isn't really gaming related, but candy and snacks.
It's fun, and Asian culture is awesome.
Yes, and it influences games more than most people
and we
know,
like
so.
Candy.
So, we'll save this one. I want to go through all of them first, and then we'll break them up and decide. These are, what is this? Potokoro cubes. They are bite-sized cubes with bold black pepper.
I like the, like, dog thing. Kind of reminds me of Pikmin, because it's got, like, the little leaf on its head.
Well, he's here on the back, if you check him out. If you check him out, he's,
he's
like a little pocket dog.
It kind of looks like a neon cat.
Yeah, well, that's what it is. Look.
Oh, sweet.
See?
Okay.
It's a little neon cat in the back. It's hard to see. Right. It's hard to see, but that's what that is. So that's the Potokoro cubes. The little frog dude. These are chameleon candy. Hard candies that change colors like a real chameleon. Choose a red one, and the chameleon grants you good luck.
Like a real chameleon.
Yep. You know, this is, that's the chameleon candy. This is sour lemon gum.
This guy looks familiar. Is there, like... You know what it reminds me of? There's, like, an Adventure Time. You've seen Adventure Time, right?
Yeah.
There's, like, some
maybe
like
it's
weird...
inspired.
It's, like,
know.
A weird,
maybe,
like, guy
maybe, maybe the
his
Adventure
name's
Time
Lemonhead,
is
I think it is. He's got a lemon, and he always
maybe
looks
Adventure
like that.
Maybe Adventure Time's inspired by that. I don't know. 10 pieces of super sour lemon gum that will leave you feeling like the lemon on the package.
I'm kind of interested.
I'm interested, too. Oh, God, this one. Okay. This is called Adzuki Mizu Yokan. A more traditional Japanese dessert. It's a red bean snack, and it's sweet with
a
gel texture.
We need to do this.
Oh, God. This sounds abysmal.
We need this so bad.
Oh, God.
I need this in my life.
That sounds awful. All right.
I'm super excited.
What's this one? This is, Lifeguard. A Lifeguard started off as a soda and now comes in many candy forms like this paste. It's a paste.
Is this the paste edition? What is going on? We got, like, bean paste, goat paste.
Oh,
what's
what the
are
heck?
Those chips?
What is that? Corn potage chips. Fluffy corn clouds that melt in your mouth. Corn potage is a popular soup in Japan.
That's awesome.
That sounds terrible, too. All right,
you're not a
one?
Corn fan?
Dude, I'm not from the Midwest. I don't know what you're talking about. What the heck is that? This is a Kajiri Chew, a refreshing
like a
chewy cola taffy. Filled with a layer of citrus soda flavored taffy. So it's a regular
citrus
cola
soda.
With citrus soda in it.
So I wonder, are we going like, is it like...
I don't know.
Orange or lemon?
Oh, God, that feels
terrible.
Is this
terrible. One of those...
Oh! Chew grape what jelly. A Japanese jelly in a convenient package. Open the tube from one end and enjoy the grape goodness.
Oh, my God. I'm scared.
That sounds awful. And then this one is called a Choco's Bar Z Kanako. Backed by popular demand, a crispy wafer stick soaked
popular
in Kanako,
demand, huh?
Which is soy flour chocolate.
That does
a subtle
not sound
yet
fun.
Sweet flavor and the newest flavor on the Z Bar line.
Z Bar.
Oh,
is this
hey,
is this related
you
to Dragon
in?
Ball Z?
Come on in. So my wife is going to join us.
I got to get out first. Or I'm not squeeze in.
She's going to join us for this one because why not, right? We're going to try some weird crap, some weird Japanese candies, and see what we think. So, Reki, you're going to have to join George on his mic.
The fun mic.
And give us some feedback.
Are you coming this way? Sure. I got to squeeze back that way.
All we see is George's back here.
Yep, George is back. George is back.
I got the best back.
Nelson's saying it sounds a bit off for a second or so. Sorry, sometimes it does drift between audio and video just because of things. Reasons, I guess. Scoot over some. Get more in.
Scoot over. You gotta get in.
I know. Chill. I can't because your room is full of crap.
I can't help it, alright? I stream. That's what I do.
I don't know if
this
might reach. It's not going to work. You got to lean in, though. Can't see your face, dork.
All right.
Well, that was scary.
Terrifying.
Go back.
So, do I need to sweep the camera
begin?
So we can see you?
No, it's fine.
Okay. All right, so, she's giving a wave to the camera there. All right, she's the disembodied hand. That's my wife, Reki. So, say hi, Reki. Say hi, so people know
hi.
You exist. There she is. She exists. All right, so what do you want to try first?
Let's try the paste.
The oh god. This is the bean jelly. All right,
it's
so
jelly, not paste.
Yeah, it's jelly.
I thought you said paste.
No, that's jelly. It's made of adzuki beans. They're red beans mashed up.
It's in a can like a dog food. Like cat food. Oh god, this is gonna be awful. It smells like beans. Give it a smell.
Smells like refried beans.
Hey, Hard Bulldog 37. Does smell like beans.
Smells like adzuki to me, which... Don't put it in your hand. Don't you have a...
Do we need a spoon? Do you want me to get a spoon?
Oh my gosh. Yeah, go get a spoon. Or get a knife and a spoon just in case.
I shall return.
This is terrifying, y'all. This thing, it actually leaked goo on my hand. It's
bean goo.
Disgusting.
It's like pudding. You're not supposed to.
It's leaking all over everything.
Because you dumped it into your hand.
Oh boy. Yeah, this stuff is going to be gross. I'm predicting. Predicting grossness.
Have you ever had adzuki before?
No, I can't say I have. So sorry. We're going culinary for the end of the show. While George gets the knife and the spoon, I know we're a little. We're kind of at the end of the normal time. We're going to go a little later to go through all these snacks. But if you like the show, please hit follow. It'll let you know the next time that we do the show on Mondays. We do it at 6:30 p.m. Eastern is when we start. But please hit follow. The dog's in here too. Cool. We're going to I also do streams just about every day except for Tuesdays and play games pretty much open to interpretation because we play just about everything. So feel free to hit follow, and it'll alert you next time we go on. We really appreciate you guys hanging out. Either way, you don't have to follow at all. It's not required, but we appreciate it greatly. So here we go.
We eat bean paste.
You gotta let Hawk out there because he's gonna get jealous. Out, Hawk. Get out.
Be free.
Out. Good boy. Here you go, George.
Why do I get the biggest spoonful I've ever
seen?
Dude,
it's tiny. That's not even half.
This is like half the jar. I'll wait for you guys.
Oh, I'm not trying that.
What?
Oh, you have to.
Oh, my God. Nope. Get out of here.
You have to.
I want a tiny... Give me my own spoon. I'll get some of my own.
You baby.
I am a giant baby.
You gotta take the whole thing, dude.
Oh, my God.
Take it like a champ.
It really just smells a lot like refried beans.
It does. Ready?
All right.
Cheers.
Oh, I got a full bean. Yeah, it's real bad.
Now, it's the texture.
It tastes like adzuki.
The flavor ain't that bad. It's the texture.
It tastes like you took refried beans and just poured a cup of sugar into it.
Yeah.
That's what it tastes like.
Sweet beans, yeah. Is that what it is? Is that what adzuki is? Red beans?
Pinto beans taste like.
Ugh.
It's red beans and sugar, and it's
more.
I go for another spoonful.
It's a traditional dessert.
So give it a rating out of 10. We won't rate games, but
5. Two.
Got a 5, really?
The taste isn't bad. The texture's off.
Texture's horrible.
Kind of grainy.
I personally like the texture more than the taste.
Oh god, I'm the other way.
The texture's kind
of
fun.
Actually, the texture's not bad. I think you're right. No,
it
now
sucks.
Now that I chew on it. I don't know. It's a 1.5 for me. It's awful. It's awful. I could grow to get used to it if I ate it a lot.
Yeah, like if someone was hitting me with a stick, I'd be like, "This is really good." But
please don't hit me.
No.
Hard Bulldog 37 says, "Bizarre foods. Where's Andrew Zimmer?"
I'm as close as you're getting, man. I'm heavy and
you need to be balder.
Give me 5.
You got to be balder. All right, what next?
I'm not there yet.
Just being your Vanna White.
Oh, thank you.
Showing off
let's
your
eat.
Amazing.
Was there
welcome back,
Mr.
Nelson. Welcome back.
That was a unique situation.
That was something.
Should we try the grape jelly now?
Oh, God, no more jellies. Let's break into the jelly last. What is this? Lifeguard paste. Do you want to do the paste?
Yes, paste.
Paste.
All right, this Woo! Is the... You got to talk into the mic, Recky.
Hello!
Hey, thanks for the follow. Appreciate it, Mr. Nelson. Welcome, welcome.
I think the aftertaste is better than the initial
taste. The aftertaste isn't bad. I'm actually digging the aftertaste.
A little sweet flavor in my mouth. It's kind of nice.
Okay. Oh, God. It comes with 3 little packets.
Perfect!
Everyone gets one.
All right, so what is this again?
This is Lifeguard...
paste. It started off as a soda and now comes in many candy forms like this paste.
Does it have a flavor?
It does not say what the flavor is.
You can kind of smell it. It smells fruity.
Citrus, probably?
Yeah.
Oh, my God. Look at that. It's like semen.
It's like plant semen.
It's like, yeah, it's like sap.
Oh, dang it. It got on me. Came on me too early.
Party foul, you gotta eat two now.
I'm just kidding. Here, take mine.
Alright, we going?
It smells.
We're waiting on you, Caitlin?
I can't tear the package.
Tim, help her out.
I got nibbly fingers.
You gotta open it to the right spot, retard.
She was opening it at the wrong spot.
You gotta look for the nick. The nick in the side.
Hey, Kitty Jung.
Kitty Jung, hello.
No worries. Please don't post links without asking permission, but I appreciate it anyways.
What? You're killing us. Open your goo.
Yeah. Thanks, George. All right, it's open.
All right, we ready? Cheers to the paste.
Cheers to the paste.
God, it's hard to get out.
It's like a gummy. Actually, it's less a paste and more of a gummy.
That's kind of weird. I was not expecting that.
Okay.
It kind of tastes like Monster.
When I was a kid, I used to get this stuff in like a toothpaste tube, and it was like a lickable...
Yeah.
Jelly.
It's like those... we have candies like this over here in the States.
Yeah.
That's not bad.
I've never had
that.
Anything like it. It tastes like a Monster to me.
A little bit. It's not bad, though.
I kind of like it.
I'm digging it.
It was nowhere near the consistency I was expecting. Because like you said, it's just like a mushed up gummy bear almost. Hard to
yeah,
grab, though.
Not bad. I'd have it. That's Lifeguard.
Seven.
Paste. I'll give it a 7.5.
No, you did.
No, actually, I'll give it an 8. I'll give it an 8. I'll bump it to an 8. Mm-hmm. The aftertaste is good, too. Interesting. So, yeah, just to reiterate.
Hold on.
Yeah.
Caitlin only put that 2 points higher than this bean stuff.
It tastes good, but I don't like the gooey.
Kitty Jung, I'd rather, I can't really give you permission to post links right now because I'm not at the computer, I'm on the other side of the room, sorry, but I can give it to you towards the end of the show. I'd be glad to.
That's probably an 8 for me.
That's pretty good, yeah. Alright, so next, let's do, what is this one? This is the Kajiri Chew, a refreshing chewy cola taffy filled with a layer of citrus soda flavored taffy. Oh boy.
That was pretty awesome, actually.
Oh, man. Here we go. We're going to do this
is
one.
Is the citrus cola what?
Yeah, the citrus cola taffy.
Split it up into bits.
Yeah. Use a knife if you need to, or does it break off pretty easy?
It breaks off pretty easy.
Okay.
It looks like a taffy.
It looks like a... what are those one cow things? Cow tails. You know what I'm talking
about?
Yeah, cow tails. That's what it looks like. Going in.
It tastes like soda.
Yeah, it's a little weird. Not bad, though.
It's like if you took those bottle cap candies and made a gooey out of it.
Mm. That's what it tastes like.
Taffy bottle caps.
Mm.
That's a good description.
Mm.
Weird.
Is it like lemon
bad.
Lime?
In the middle, yeah, it's a citrus flavored soda. So lemon lime.
That's really all I'm tasting is the citrus.
It's not bad. Not bad.
What's
at all.
The outer part supposed to be?
Well, it cola.
Tastes,
tastes a little.
Got like a.
Like almost a carbonated.
Soda. Yeah, exactly. Mm-hmm. Yeah, like a foamy kind of feel.
That's pretty good. I recommend that one. I'll give that one a 7.
6.
6?
7.
6.5. Yeah. 6. Give it a 6.5. That one's pretty good. That's called a Kajiri Chew from this month's Japan crate.
7.
Mmm.
About on par with the jelly.
All right. This one's going to be tough.
What is this?
Podokoro Cubes. You might recognize this from this dog from the cover.
Dog?
Savory bite-sized cubes with bold black pepper.
I like black pepper, so I'm probably
I don't
not.
Like pepper. I don't want to try this one.
You're trapped. You have no choice.
Here we go.
I like... This is not what we're eating right now, but I really like this pot guy.
He's so surprised.
He's like, ah! What's happening?
Becky?
Oh, they're tiny.
Yeah, they're little cubes.
They look like home fries, almost.
Give you two.
I can't see that.
You can get a second opinion.
They do kind of look... Or, what are those things you put on salads?
Croissants.
No, croutons.
Go. Croutons.
Here, take a third. I got three. Here we go.
Going all three at once, or just one at a time?
Just one at a time. Not bad. Little weird.
peppery.
It tastes like pretty a home potato-y, fry.
Yeah. But it tastes like a it tastes like a home fry with a lot of pepper on it.
You know, give me some more of that. I actually like those.
Dude, that tastes that's not bad. Like fresh potato taste.
That was the one I was most scared of, and I think it's the one I like the best.
Really?
Yeah, I told you I don't like pepper.
This is the least scary one for me.
Actually, this is a good palate cleanser. Like, not gonna lie.
Like that was gonna be
here.
Dangerous. These are awesome.
Mm-hmm.
These are really good.
I give these ones a 7.5.
These are like 8.
Yeah, I'd eat these. I'd go 9. I eat them all the time.
Yeah, they're really good.
Not bad. Those are the Podocoro cubes, which I'm actually pleasantly surprised at. So hooray. We found a surprising winner.
God, that was really awesome.
Right, you can have Caitlin, that
tear
later.
Those up.
All right. Don't have them right now.
I say have them.
What should we do now? Why don't we do... I don't want to do the Z-Bar yet. I kind of already have
Here we go. Color changing, guys.
If you get the red one, you win.
Chameleon.
Start out red or turns red?
It turns red. They're all brown to start.
I feel like that's a bad color to start with. I don't like brown candies.
Becky, show the camera.
They kind of look like grapes.
Little brown cubes. They look like milk duds.
So wait, so they start changing when you're eating them?
They're like gobstoppers.
Yeah.
Oh, you suck on them.
Yeah.
Okay.
All I'm tasting is pepper right now.
I taste a grape.
Yeah, oh, there's a grape.
Mine's grape.
Mm-hmm.
Are they all grape?
Mm, probably.
We all just get grape?
The outside.
Okay. Oh, that's probably why they're brown.
That's not too bad. It is just like a
just color change?
It is just like a gobstopper, though. Color will change. It's supposed to change color. Hmm.
I'm not the biggest fan of grape, though.
Mm.
Grape is really low on my scale of flavors I enjoy. I'm trying, you know.
Trying to see. Oh, there we go. Mine turned red.
Is mine red? I don't know what mine... What are the colors? So it's
Is that red? Or is that pink?
That's probably red. Because it's only red, yellow, or green, so...
Mm. I think we all got red. We are all winners!
Yeah!
Lucky! Kanpai!
We win! I think I might... Yeah, I was about to say, I'm about to chop mine.
Actually, very good flavor.
Yeah.
That was hard.
I don't think I'm going to do that.
You just break your teeth?
Oh, God. No, that was a horrible idea.
They're quite tasty once you get past the grape.
Yeah.
Dude, when I cracked open it, it's awesome now.
Yeah, that's delicious.
If my teeth could take it, I'd pop like 20 of them and just chew them.
Oh, my God. That was one of the hardest candies I think I've ever tried to bite in my life.
Ow, ow, ow. It's all caught in my teeth.
But I can't tell if I'm eating my tooth or the candy anymore.
Definitely pink. Red pink.
Like, that was... Wow.
Nice. We're all lucky. Hooray.
Don't bite them.
All right. So we're going to keep these.
I give that a 9.5. That's really good.
Damn.
I really like those.
I give that one an 8.5.
Once you get past the grape, they're pretty awesome.
I give that an 8.5 because it's cool, too.
Because I don't know what the other flavors are going to be like.
Mm-hmm. But it's cool, too, though. That concept is pretty cool. You get lucky if... So I'm getting lucky.
God, that hurts.
Yeah.
That was like the worst idea ever.
All right. So this one is the Mac and Gummy. This is the Rock, Paper, Scissors.
Scissors.
This one's already scissors. We know that. I think. We'll double check.
Is it?
Yep. Scissors.
Sweet.
And you want to show the camera?
So wait, those are like those things you go whoosh.
No. It's actual
it's candy,
food.
But I mean, it's like that's
it,
what
it looks like
to be
it,
like,
yeah.
Right?
It's similar.
Caitlin gets
But if you
star.
Hit something with it, it's going to get all gamey. All
right, I'll go with that. I'll get the star. Who gets the hand and who gets the arm?
I'll take the arm. Tim, you can get the scissors.
Okay. Star for you. And this is definitely just like a...
No, this is grape, right?
I'm pretty sure, so prep yourself.
I'm gonna jiggle mine for fun.
Blech.
I caught a worm.
It's actually pretty, it's a lot thicker and less wiggly than I thought it would be.
Yeah. Oh, that's grape for sure. God, I hate grape.
It's either cola or grape.
Mine is grape for 100% grape. Because I hate it.
Oh yeah, I smell the grape already.
This is like, this is a 4.
No, you don't like grape though.
Mm-hmm.
I'll give it a
maybe 5.
I'll give it a 7. No, I'll give it a 6.5. A 6.5.
It's a really tough gummy. It's like definitely not very like gooey gummy. It's definitely harder.
Mm.
So I like it. I gave it a 6.
Okay.
You like grape?
No, that's why it got so low.
Okay.
The texture is good.
And then we
the
got grape jelly
off.
Still.
Let's do this because I want to finish everything grape and just be done.
All right, here we go. Here we go.
And this, you got to, like, pipe it out and stuff.
Oh, just... God.
Oh, my God.
It's like a tube of doom.
Dude, that is menace. That is like a syringe.
Full of jelly.
Oh, God.
Full of jelly.
Which part's the tip?
This one.
Really, you have to ask.
Get your spoon.
That's the most awkward thing I've ever seen. This is Caitlin's.
Just a tiny bit, please. Not a big fan.
Sure, you don't want a big load of grape.
No, I think I'll pick my little tiny.
I spooged a bit on
the paper. Tim, party
pal. Oh, dude.
You never can shoot your grape too early.
Oh,
that is just bad.
Show the camera, Recky.
It comes out too easily.
Not... Oh.
Yeah, it slips and slides all over the place.
I'm going to man up. I'm just going to do it straight.
You're just
going to
take the lot right in your gullet, man.
I dumped it all over my hands.
Insert coin theater watchers to you.
Open your throats.
Cam pie.
Oh, dude. The consistency is the worst thing in the world.
Oh, my God.
Mm-mm.
Oh, boy.
No. Mm-mm.
You know, it tastes just like Jell-O. It tastes just like Jell-O to me.
It's too...
Yeah, it's
too,
like Jell-O down your throat.
Yeah, it's too liquidy, man.
That's a one.
How are you supposed to eat Jell-O?
That's a one. That's a one.
That was,
I hate Jell-O, and I hate the way it
I
feels.
I wish I could give that back. It's just...
You know, if it was cherry or some other flavor, it'd be pretty high, so I'm going to say 5.5.
Oh,
really?
My God.
Yeah.
The consistency was horrible.
Oh.
It was like...
I didn't mind it at all.
I feel like I've been violated by a grape
giant. You shouldn't have taken that big of a
lie,
man. You shouldn't have did all that.
I took one for the team.
Are you going back for seconds?
I took that much. I took, like, almost half of that.
I'm impressed.
You're actually going back for seconds?
I'm impressed, because that was just the worst.
Hey, Hard Bulldog, thanks for the like on Facebook. And Mr. Nailson's laughing at us.
That was, man. That was a bad idea.
That was awful. All right. Next up, let's do the Z-Bar.
There's nothing else grape, right?
Jello, yeah.
No, there's no more grape.
Okay.
All right, that is all the grape. All that's left is the kit, which I don't know how to make.
No, that one takes...
Refrigeration. Time, so. Yeah, it's refrigeration.
Pass.
It's not,
pass.
Not gonna happen.
Aw, Wolf. Wolf's laughing at me, too. He's being mean, too. All right, so what do you want to do? Do you want to do the Z-Bar, or do you want to do the corn potage?
Let's do
Z-Bar.
Z-Bar. All right, we'll break that into thirds. Let's keep rolling. Keep going. Yeah. I almost choked. What can I say? It was gross.
No.
That one got crunched a bit, so we just get a piece. Give me that.
I'm going to just snap it. Is there three pieces, or just crack it in half? Oh, is it single?
It broke. Take the big one, man.
Now, what is this again?
The Z-Bar. It's a Choco Z-Bar Kanako. Backed by popular demand, a crispy wafer stick soaked in Kanako soy flour chocolate. A subtle yet sweet flavor.
Some
the newest flavor
corny.
In the Z-Bar. Z-Bar. Whatever.
It should taste like popcorn.
I love the
consistency. Not bad. Mm-hmm. It's like those wafers. The wafer bars that you can get.
Mm-hmm.
Those are really good.
Hello!
Hey, thanks for the follow.
All I taste is puffed corn.
Appreciate it.
I don't taste the Kanako or the chocolate or anything else. Just puffed corn.
That was Mass Effect 1171.
Thank you.
We were talking about Mass Effect earlier. I hope you caught that. Appreciate you hitting that follow button.
That
truly, truly do. You're awesome.
I really enjoyed.
That was actually pretty good. It's like a wafer stick.
It's almost like a Cheeto with no cheese powder.
Yeah. Yeah. It's got that like texture and consistency. Mm-hmm. I don't mind that. You want to split the rest of this?
Bring it on.
Yeah, no, I'm going to give that one a 4. Tolerable, but not pleasant.
I think it's pretty good.
That's like an 8 for me.
All right. What's up? Uh-oh. Did we freeze? I don't think we froze. I hope we're not frozen. We're still streaming according to OBS, so there's still audio coming through. I think my stream just froze on that. Uh-oh. Mass Effect says he froze. Let's see if I can get this working.
That is really good. We almost made it all the way through, too.
Try it again. Yeah, it's working again.
Sweet.
No,
it hiccuped.
Not. Oh, it's an
S. That's a yeah.
It hiccuped. You may need to refresh. Sorry about that. Okay, Nelson says that is not frozen. So, it was just frozen on our end. Sorry. All right, so we're going to go with the corn potage chips.
These I'm very excited about.
We're going to finish up
with the super sour gum.
With the super sour gum.
You can get it out.
They look like little little tiny ears of corn.
Do they? Oh, it's awesome.
A little bit.
They smell They smell like Kix cereal.
They do smell like...
That's a Cheeto.
Dude, that is a weird...
That's a weird flavor. So, it says that...
Oh, God. It's like...
Pour me a couple.
It says corn potage is a popular soup in Japan.
I don't know what this tastes like.
Hey, George. In a second, do you want to go get the drink that I put in there? It's it looks like a beer bottle almost. I'm giving that one a 2.
Two. Gross.
Giving it a 2.
Gross.
It's not very good.
The texture's fine, but the
I'll up that to 2.5.
It's surprisingly sweet.
It's like corn, but like it's like eating creamed canned corn.
Yeah, it's like eating creamed corn. That's a good one. You know what? Now that I've connected that,
it's full on cream corn.
I'm gonna bump myself to a 4.5. I love cream corn. I'll have another one.
After a few, it's pretty good.
There it is.
It's full on cream corn.
Cream corn.
I'm glad I increased your enjoyment.
Hey, Swifty, how's it
going,
man?
You made this delicious. This is awesome.
Swifty just popped in.
Oh, you're missing the good stuff, Swifty.
All right,
cream corn chips.
Okay,
gross.
So do you want to do this very last? Do you want to go get the drink now? Because this is going to screw up our taste buds really bad. It's going to jack it up.
Let me finish my cream corn puff.
We're expecting everyone to make this face.
I hope I make that face.
They said you will be that guy by the end.
You will be. You will be.
This guy right here. I want to see this on that.
Swifty, we are not drunk. We are trying out weird Japanese candies and sweets and stuff from the, it's called a Japan Crate. They have a website. They aren't sponsoring us, though I wish they would. Very, very interesting stuff that you can get out of it. It's like $30 shipped, 2-day shipping. I, at this point, wish I were drunk so I could deal with that cream corn flavor. Don't open it yet. What are you doing? We're not ready.
Cream corn candy.
Yeah. All right.
Is it?
Yes, it is.
It comes in, I figured it would, but it comes in little...
Oh, little packets.
Little okay.
So
this...
This
is really good.
Becky, will you show this off?
Yep.
This is called kids beer.
Kids beer?
Oh, yeah.
It says, of course there's
now
no alcohol
party
in this yummy apple soda. See page 6 for a full description. Let's see page 6.
So it's supposed to be like cider?
No, listen to the description.
It says, in Japan, people follow a certain set of customs when enjoying drinks with coworkers, friends, and family. Traditions such as never pouring your own glass, taking the first sip together, and always including a kanpai, or cheers, create a feeling of community. Kid beer was invented to include children in this ritual.
Love that.
And has become very popular. It is even sold in Japanese bars and restaurants. And I'm leaking jelly everywhere. So, over here, if you called it kids' beer,
yeah,
you would get
a good job on that, this
crucified.
Cream corn for days.
Corn
no,
for days.
Swifty, kids' beer, not kids' bear.
Yeah, there's a kids' bear inside of the beer.
So, Mr. Nelson, cream corn is where they take cream and they pretty much just blend it into like this really like creamy consistency.
It's corn.
It's a little like if you've ever had like grits. It's a little like grits, but pure corn.
And they take
right. Is that pretty accurate?
Corn kernels just, off of the cob and put it in a can and then put some water in
yes.
there. So it's like watery corn kernel corn.
But they
it's got
they
a
mash
thicker
it.
Consistency.
It's mashed a
it's
bit.
It's like
it's mashed a little bit.
Almost a little syrupy consistency.
Yeah, it's like
and
I,
very
I feel
sweet.
Like I feel like it's like grits.
It's a southern
it's
thing.
Just sweeter.
And it's gross.
It's pretty darn good.
Southern boy.
I love cream corn.
Southern boy.
Cuban.
Hey, I like me some cream corn.
Okay. So let's try this.
So let's
not southern.
Before you drink it, you have to say kanpai. That's going to be our rule.
Kanpai.
No, when you get the bottle.
Oh.
She's too early. She has to be punished now. Eat another
party foul.
Corn.
Eat another cream corn chip.
No.
So here we go. Kids beer.
Kanpai.
Kanpai.
Wait, I missed it. Is it supposed to taste like beer?
No, it's supposed to be an apple soda.
Okay.
It's supposed to look like beer. So
that's a friggin' weird flavor. You didn't say kanpai!
Kanpai! No! No, 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 no.
I was gonna
going to be the new punishment, cream corn puffs, when you do wrong.
That's a weird flavor.
Is it supposed to taste like beer, though?
It tastes a little...
It smells like cream soda.
It tastes a little like beer, cream soda, and apple mixed.
Like apple cream soda.
With beer thrown in.
That's weird.
Is that not weird? That is a freaking weird flavor.
That is like cream soda mixed with like apples.
It's bizarre, isn't it?
I don't know if I like it or not. I feel like I kind of like it, but I'm not sure.
I know. I'd have to have like one or two more to really know and then be like, nah, I don't like that.
Like, it's super sweet. Super creamy.
It's so sweet.
Why don't we get a cup and see what it looks like?
Yeah, I'm curious.
Because it's supposed to look like beer.
Yeah, go ahead. It had tea in it, and it's tiny bit. It won't affect the flavor if you put enough. Just pour the whole thing in there. So we're gonna pour the whole thing in and see. Watch it get like a head, like a real beer.
Oh, I wouldn't.
It is too. Oh my god,
that's pretty awesome.
That's amazing. It looks just awesome. Like a real beer. You're doing your pour all wrong, though.
All right, Mr. Beer Snob. No, I'm not eating another one. It's
party foul.
Not
corn punishment.
Ugh. It's our Batsu. And for those of you who don't know, a Batsu game is like a punishment if you do it wrong. That looks just like a beer.
That looks really awesome. It kind of reminds me of a butter beer.
Oh, yeah.
It does look a little like a butter beer. That's a lot of head.
Yeah.
even for like a beer, that's a lot of head.
Not actually beer.
Yeah, but that is kids' beer, not kids' bear. Thanks,
so
Swifty.
Kids can pretend to be drunk in the office people.
Yes, kids can be indeed.
We're wasted, too.
Bro, I totally wasted all this kid's beer.
Come by, bro.
Come by.
Come by, bro.
This is a huge
I'm episode. So wasted. Come by.
I kind of like it after.
Dude.
It's just weird.
Give me another.
Dude, I'm so combined right now.
The come by has hit me hard, man.
So what do we think? I think 6.
Yeah,
I'm gonna
like
give it a 6.5. I'm gonna put it on the upper end of that.
I like it, but I don't know that I could drink a lot of it. So I'm
this is like a one hitter quitter.
6.5, yeah.
You know,
this is it's really really sweet. So
it's
like
super
one,
sweet. Yeah,
one and you're you
one
be
and done
sick after. Yeah,
can't buy, bro.
Yeah, one and done.
But it looks amazing. 8+.
Yeah, it's perfect visually. I think they focus more on the look than the flavor. All right, here we go.
I already put pieces out for you.
Lemon sweet. Gum. All right, these are the lemon gum. All right, this is supposed to be so sour it makes your face look like
a lemon.
Ooh, dude, it smells like it's going to be potent.
There we go.
Oh my god, dude. It is like...
This is like... You're sucking on a lemon it smells like. Wait for us. It looks like those gums you'd get tattoos in.
Can't buy, bro.
You know what I'm talking about?
Yeah, it smells intense.
I can't even...
Can't dude, online. You wait, gotta be smarter wait. Than the wrapper.
That's gonna be bad.
Let's do it. Ready?
Salute.
Kanpai?
Kanpai!
Kanpai! Nothing yet.
Oh, it's getting there.
In the space.
Oh, no.
It's coming. Oh, yeah.
Towards the camera, Tim.
Oh, there we go. That's it.
Joe got
Yep. It's like getting punched in the uterus.
That is sour. Woo!
Dude.
Oh, my eyes are watering.
They were right.
Look exactly
they
like
were right.
The lemon guy. Wait, look towards the camera.
Put it to the camera. Put it up to the camera. Recky, put it up to the camera so they have a reference.
They were spot on.
Wow. Oh, man.
My turn.
It wasn't that bad for me.
Your piece was jacked, son, because mine was like over 9,000. The amount of saliva I got in my mouth right now.
Oh, my God.
Could, like, kill a goat.
I think Greggy's face is melting.
And it stayed, man. It's going.
Mine
isn't
melting.
Oh, man.
I might have to swallow it.
Just spit it out, dude. That's what the box is there for. I'm throwing all that stuff out.
Where's my
except
wrapper?
For the silverware. Keep the silverware. That stuff's expensive.
It's been contaminated by the grape.
And the jelly.
The bean paste.
The bean paste.
Nine. I love this.
Come by, bro. Come by.
I'm crying. I love this.
That was pretty awesome.
That was pretty great.
It was worth the pain.
I didn't have much pain. It's good though. It was still pretty sour. I give it a. I give it four awesome. It's not bad flavor either.
I
like Japanese gum because
it's accurate.
Yeah, but I like Japanese gum because it's the texture is a little bit softer.
It's softer, yeah.
And I love that. And you can blow really big bubbles with it too. It's cool. I love blowing bubbles. So I'll give it
7.
You know, I'm gonna give that one an 8. I like that a lot. That was really good, and it has a good. I love Japanese gum also because it has a good aftertaste. Because
it lasted pretty long.
Because they use real sugar still. They don't use like corn, you know, based stuff. So
aspartame.
Mm-hmm. So the flavor sticks with you, and it's really really good. So I like it.
That was pretty awesome.
Woo!
It was 7 because it was my face was that face.
That's true. It's exactly accurate. It's exactly what it was. So. That brings us to the end of this month's Japan Crate.
I'm going
to
chase it with some apple
next cream. Month, you want to do this again? All right, so the next Japan Crate we get, we're going to do the same exact thing. We're going to tear it open, and we're going to try some snacks. And thank you all so very, very much for hanging out
with
us tonight.
It was a fun ride.
Please, 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 please hit follow if you had fun, if you haven't followed yet. It'll let you know next time we're live. We will be here. George and I will be here next Monday, 6:30. Rain or shine, if George gets hit by a bus, I'm still going.
Just
so,
drag my corpse.
Yep. I'm going to put him up like a puppet and be like... Woo, 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 woo.
Just have somebody work me from behind.
Recky can do it.
Yeah. Like, just like that.
Exactly. So, yeah, please hit follow. I stream throughout the week. I'll be playing games whenever I get time. Never well. It's usually after, like, 6 o'clock p.m. Eastern time is when I get a chance to play. But come hang out and talk, and, I mean, I'm all up for talking about just about anything. So if you have, like, something you want to discuss that's not during the show, you can. And if it's a good topic, we can take it to the show with us. And it's always fun. And I love making new friends and meeting new people, and so does George. And that's Recky,
can you
my
pull
wife.
It off the bubble only on the side
hand.
Edge? Too deep. Too deep.
It's just our...
So thanks again,
thanks
y'all.
Thanks for joining, guys.
And we will see you guys next week, I hope. And hope you had
rain
fun.
Rain or shine.
Rain or shine. Unless George is dead, then he's going to be a ventriloquist dummy.
And there'll be less shine and more rain.
Yeah. Aw. And again, we dedicate this episode
to Mr.
Iwata. So thank you so much. You're going to be missed. And we really appreciate everything that he's done for us. And he will always be in our thoughts. And our thoughts are with Nintendo and his family right now. And if you all get a chance, take a moment of silence for Mr. Iwata. It's a big deal that he's passed away. And it will have a lasting effect. Yeah, get out of my head. On the gaming industry as a whole. So, thank you very much. I'm Tim.
I'm George.
And
this is Recky.
She's Recky. And we will we'll see you guys next week. Woohoo!
Peace!